I found this team has an opportunity to make history here tonight and be in uncharted territory and, you know, face and be in the regional final next weekend.
One of the things that's happened is that there has been all sorts of new excitement around the team, the buzz created from the victory that they just had a week ago against London. We're going to step aside. When we come back, we'll continue to set the table for this one. You're listening to high school football and Bellefontaine Chieftains football on 107.3 The Drive.
If you've never been to Saucy Sal's, you need to check it out. It's easy to find at the roundabout at State Route 47 and 235. They offer fresh deli meats, cheeses, and choice meats. They have it all. Saucy Sal's sauces and mustards are the best. That's why so many area restaurants use them. Pick up your favorites at Saucy Sal's. They offer fresh baked goods from Der Dutchman and lots of Walnut Creek items. There's even frozen food. Prices are reasonable and the service is great. Hurry to Saucy Sal's soon. When you're hungry for great Italian food, but you're also in a hurry, try Fazoli's of Bellefontaine. They offer delicious Italian meals like spaghetti and meatballs and chicken Alfredo fettuccine. They also offer great pizza and oven-baked subs. Be sure to download their rewards app. You'll get special offers, plus every dollar you spend, you get reward. Open till 9.
Back at Bolas Field in London, getting set for football tonight in the Sweet 16 of the Division 3 Region 11. Dave Bezusko alongside with Brandon Stockton as we have the Bellefontaine Chieftains coming in. The seventh seed in Region 11, they are 10-2 on the season. The Grandview Blue Aces are 12-0, and they are the three seed. Brandon, back to the scene of the crime where the Chieftains extended their season last week with the upset win over London, a spirited victory that has gotten them on the brink of some school history tonight, and the Chiefs have now won six in a row playing their best football of the season.
Yeah, last week, you know, me and you on the way down here talked about, you know, what Bellefontaine had to do to try to slay the dragon, you know, that they haven't been able to slay the last 7 years, and, you know, what a better opportunity than in the playoffs. And I think tonight, same successful recipe is that you have to be able to balance attack what they showed last week. You know, Tavian had four touchdowns, 200 and some yards passing. Chris Fogan had, you know, again having, you know, when it mattered the most, they ran him and he was able to pick up first downs and kind of ice things. So I think for Bellefontaine to win here tonight, I think it's going to be a close game. I know there's a lot of people that think that, you know, Granville has some players out on defense, and some people think that's going to be a blowout. But I just think that, you know, Bellefontaine shouldn't change anything. Continue to do what they've done all season, and, you know, in the fourth quarter, see where you're at.
Both teams are getting set to take the field now, and they both do so simultaneously as the lights flash on and off here. The strobe lighting at Bolas Field that we experienced a week ago with the Red Raiders at their home team tonight on this neutral field. The Chieftains run out in their all-white jerseys and pants and black helmets to that far sideline where the stands are absolutely packed.
They showed out.
I mean, my goodness, along the railing for the Bellefontaine Chieftains, the fans 3-4 deep. Perhaps it was the last person out that turned out the lights in Bellefontaine tonight. Don't know who's back home listening to us tonight, but I'll tell you what, a terrific turnout to follow the Chiefs. This redemption tour continues. I don't have to remind Chieftain fans what happened a year ago in the opening round of the playoffs when they fell to Granville on the last play of the game. A potential touchdown to Caden Reams from Tavian St. Clair ruled out of bounds and incomplete that coulda, woulda won the ball game. You know, you got the video, you got some pictures. It was really close, Brandon. Could have gone the other way. It didn't. There's nothing you can do about it.
Well, here's the thing. I mean, yeah, you want to bring – I mean, I've seen a lot of posts and a lot of, on social media, but here's the thing. They're two different teams. You know, Granville graduated a lot of seniors last year. Those guys don't – some of these guys that's playing now probably don't even remember it, to be honest with you. But, I mean, it's a new team. And, you know, just focus on the opportunity and the task at hand for Bellefontaine.
Here come the Granville Blue Aces as they take the field. And, boy, oh, boy, they have a lot of fans on the home side cheering and whooping and hollering as well. As this is a team that has been playoff tested under their head coach, Wes Schroeder. They have been to the postseason seven straight years, including the state final four in 2021. So this is definitely a team that knows how to play at this stage in the season.
He came from Olentangy, I think it was. Is that what they said?
What was that?
Their head coach came from Olentangy.
Yes, that's right.
Uh-huh. So, I mean, you know, big-time football over there. So I look for, you know, Granville to – it's not going to be an easy task for Bellefontaine, I don't think, here tonight. Like I said, they're going to have a balanced attack, try to attack Granville and, you know, with rushing and have a lot of balance here.
Let me ask you a question. You played football. You played playoff football and at this level, too, in the postseason.
Yes, sir.
How excited were you throughout the course of game day? I mean, how hard was it to be in school and to do all the things that you do during the day? I mean, what was that game day routine like in the postseason?
You know, you just went about your day. And then once you got out of class, I mean, that's when the excitement started. And, you know, the bus drive is what sucked is, you know, we drove an hour and a half to Waterson. That's what was terrible. So, you know, you're excited throughout the day. Of course these kids are excited, but you got to contain that until 7:30. Well, we played at 7:30, so in the 7 o'clock, you got to contain that until 7 o'clock.
A reminder for those who might be listening tonight, if you want to watch the game, you can do so. Our broadcast is being piped in statewide on the NFHS Network, nfhsnetwork.com, and you can watch it there, the video stream. You'll have to plunk down a fee for the month, but you'll get to watch a whole bunch of games the rest of the postseason, nfhsnetwork.com. And it will also be streaming at peakofohiotv.com tomorrow morning. peakofohiotv.com. Watch the game in its entirety tomorrow. Lou Vito and Gary Kauffman are with us here tonight as well, Brandon. We've got Evan Cook back at the studios for the radio side of things, and we're almost ready to go here tonight in London. Bellefontaine going to receive the football first, and they are ready to do so with return men off to our right, the ball being put on the 40-yard line, teed up to our left, and the kicker, Bodie Shopes, getting ready to boot it away for the Granville Blue Aces. Granville in blue, navy blue tops with white numbers, white pants, silver helmets. Bellefontaine, white tops, white bottoms with black helmets. And here comes Shopes approaching the football. Puts his right foot into it. It's a high and deep kick, end over end. Sends the return man, Riley Neer, back into the end zone for the automatic touchback. And so Bellefontaine will start at the 20-yard line.
They got a nice boot in there. Look at his shoes. His shoes are pretty cool. Got the orange shoes going on there.
Fashion
of
Bodie Shopes.
Those are soccer cleats, man.
All right, Tavian St. Clair, your Buckeye-bound Bellefontaine quarterback, the junior, completing 71% of his passes this season for 2,716 yards. How about this ratio of 34 touchdowns to 4 interceptions? And Tavian will start in the shotgun with an empty set. 3 receivers wide to the far side right, another to the near side left. And on first down, they set up the screen. Riley Neer makes the catch. He's got a bubble of blockers in front of him and skirts out to the 27-yard line for a quick gain of 7.
Yeah, nice. You know, one of the Bellefontaine staple, you know, their favorite play, I would say, one of their favorite plays is, you know, the little bubble screen off to the wide side of the field. And, you know, nice blocking over there by CJ. And can't tell who that other wide receiver is over there.
Zane Tevis.
Zane, you know, picks up 7 yards on first
down. Second down and 3 for the Chieftains at the 27-yard line. They come out from the right side end zone. The handoff up the middle to Chris Fogan. He goes straight ahead into the line up the far side hash, and he falls down backward across the line to gain to the 31. They'll move the sticks. Chris Fogan, the senior, rushed for over 1,100 yards now, and a good early mix of run and pass on the first series.
Yeah, first two plays of the game, you know, picked up 7 yards on the screen pass, and, you know, Fogan was able to pick up the first down and, you know, give Bellefontaine a new set of downs here early on in the first quarter.
It'll be, again, 3 receivers to the far side right. That's the short side of the field. Tavian St. Clair looking this side left. Hits C.J. Wilson out over the 35. Tries to shed the tackler along the near sideline, and he's not able to get out of it. Good stop made by Cooper Phillips, a linebacker who hung with him and grabbed on for dear life, dragging as Wilson tried to drag him with his heels. Mm-hmm. Did so up to the 39-yard line for a gain of 8.
Yeah, You know, Granville's DBs are playing, well, on this side of the field, is playing about 8-9 yards off the receiver. So, you know, right early on, you know, Bellefontaine's just taking what they can give them, or Bellefontaine's taking what Granville gives them here early on.
It'll be second down and two. Opening drive of the game, 1:30 in, no score. Bellefontaine and Granville in the Sweet 16. Draw play, handoff Fogan. Fogan tries the right side, runs into some defenders, keeps the legs churning and falls forward ahead for the first down. Out to the 42-yard line, move the sticks. The Chiefs are 2-for-2 on this opening series.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, just taking what Granville gives them. They're not, you know, they're here I think you're seeing is I think they're trying to bait Granville's DBs as, you know, they have some players out with injury from, you know, yearly ending season ending injuries and from last week, but just kind of baiting Granville in, see what they're going to do, and, you know, probably here take a shot downfield.
They're missing Kyle Kirby, a linebacker. He's their top tackler. Got hurt in week 9. Handoff goes to Fogan. Tries the far side. Threw a hole at the midfield stripe. He gets taken down along that far side after a gain of 11. Chris Fogan to the 48-yard line of Granville. A big hole on the right side for the Chieftains and another first down.
Yeah, Granville's fans in front of us are calling for a hold. Kind of close, but, you know, these officials are now, you know, you're not getting – you know, any Joe Blow that's going to be official down here. So you're going to get the guys that's going to, you know, call a good game. So, but, you know, nice play there for Bellefontaine as Jack Varner was able to, you know, pull out and lead the way for Chris Fogan.
Sweet 16-level referees as well, huh? Fogan empties the backfield. Tavian all back by himself, takes the snap, fires the ball deep over the top. Riley Nears open at the 10, makes the catch at the 5. He's into the end zone, touchdown, right over the middle and over the top. Tavian St. Clair to Riley Near. They connect for the 20th time this season. And from 48 yards out, it is 6-0 Bellefontaine.
You can see him baiting him. As I said earlier, you know, a couple plays ago, they were baiting him. And, you know, that DB was just nice double move there by Riley Near as he was able to, you know, separate himself from the DB and hook up with Tavian.
And now Alex Crable on for the Fissile floor covering extra point. Alex Crable is 47-53 on point after touchdowns this season. The snap from Brody Boy, the hold by Riley Near, the kick by Crable is good. And with 9:11 to play in the first quarter, your score on the Quest Federal Credit Union scoreboard, it is Bellefontaine 7 and Granville nothing. We'll step aside. You're listening to Bellefontaine Chieftains football on 107.3 The Drive.
Integrity Ford of Bellefontaine is more than just the home of the $29.95 oil change. It's the home of Ford in Logan County. Yes, at last, you loyal Ford owners have choices. Once again, you can find the Ford you want locally. And once again, there's a fully staffed service and parts department completely up to date with today's Ford technology. Finally, you can count on Integrity Ford for integrity. Because after all, the most important thing a dealer can give you is trust. Integrity Ford on 68 just south of Bellefontaine and at 9374.
Bellefontaine takes the opening kickoff. They go 6 plays, 80 yards. It's Tavian St. Clair to Riley Near. Their 20th touchdown connection, and it was a thing of beauty over the top.
I figured it was. You know, like I said, they were baiting them. They baited them with those short, you know, out plays, and, you know, Riley ran it out enough, and it was wide open.
He was one-on-one coverage, wasn't it?
Yeah, here's
the
thing.
You got to double-team Riley.
You got to have a safety over the top, but.
They have Jack Yeager and Jacob Culver back for this Dairy Queen of Bellefontaine kickoff. It goes to the far side, and here comes Yeager.
Ooh,
out over the middle. He got ahead to the 30-yard line and goes down. They peel him off the turf. Decent field position for the Granville Blue Aces. They come out with a stellar quarterback of their own, Beckett Long, a junior. 185 of 283 on the season for 2,526 yards, 25 touchdowns to 8 interceptions. Brandon, he also brings it with his legs, 750 rushing yards and 13 more scores that way. His top receivers, Dante Verasso, Jacob Culver, and Jack Yeager. Noah Musick's in the backfield as well. But they're missing Kyle Kirby, who was their top running back. Again, as their top tackler on defense, also their top back. They put 4 receivers in a triangle formation to the near side and pass to the far side. And Verasso makes the catch one-on-one. He's tackled by a host of Chieftains, including Jaden Temple and Riley Neer, but not before he gets out to the 37-yard line, a gain of 7 on first down for the Blue Aces.
You know what's crazy about it? I was sitting here counting, seeing the roster, because I don't know much about Granville, but they have 9 seniors.
A young team that graduated a lot from the playoff team that beat Bellefontaine last year in round one. Long came to the line of scrimmage, looked like he wanted to snap, and now everyone stands away. Long will be in the shotgun. He's got Music to his left. They've got 3 receivers to the near side right and another to the far side left. And from the 37-yard line, it'll be a fake handoff. Long wants to throw deep. He throws it long, far sideline. Riley Neer was back there, and he almost picked it off back at the 40-yard line of the Chiefs. Verasso was the intended target, but the ball was overthrown and off the mark.
Oh, my gosh, yeah. He overthrew his receiver probably by about 5 yards. Looked like Riley was the intended receiver on that play. So good defense there by Riley.
Bring up a third down play here, and the Chiefs have a chance to get off the field 3 and out. 8:15 to play. First quarter, Bellefontaine's got the early 7-0 lead here in London. Look at how many people are here on that Bellefontaine side.
That's absurd.
It is crazy how many people are over there. The bleachers are completely full, and it looks like there's a student body section standing between the bleachers and the concession stand. And here's a fake handoff to Music, pass near side. It's caught. Caught over the middle. It's complete to Jaeger. He's got the first down across the 45 to the 47-yard line. A pickup of 10, and the Blue Aces move the sticks.
Yeah, nice little slant, or it is a little curl in, you know, right up the hashes, and, you know, right behind the linebacker, right in front of the safety. And, you know, that was a nice throw by the quarterback.
Granville with blue tops, white pants, silver helmets with a blue and white G on it that looks either like your Green Bay Packers or your Georgia Bulldogs G. Take your pick.
You said Dallas Cowboys.
They have Dallas Cowboys colors. They do. Here's a fake to the far side, pass to the near side with the screen, and it's set up with blockers. A completion to Culver into Bellefontaine territory all the way down to the 37-yard line. That play was set up well as Long faked a pass left, and that drew some defenders and then came back to the right for a pickup of about 15 yards.
Yeah, nice little throwback play there. He, you know, started out going, you know, curling, going right or going left, come back to the right. Set up blockers. Nice play there by Granville.
First and 10, Blue Aces at the 37-yard line. They move from left to right here at Bullis Field in London. Clock at 7:15 and counting here in quarter one. Bellefontaine with their early 7-0 lead. They score it on their first possession, and now the Blue Aces looking to answer. It's going to be a handoff up the middle to Music, and Music straight into the pile, down the hashes to about the 33-yard line.
Got about 4 there.
He sure did. Getting up from the bottom of the pile for Bellefontaine is Jack Varner. It'll be second down and 6.
You remember me telling you earlier this week what the Granville reminded me of?
Yeah, Bellefontaine.
Yeah.
A lot of mirror image almost, huh?
It is.
In that they run a similar style offense.
Mm-hmm.
It's a little dark, let's just say that. Give him credit.
And they spread the field this time with no one in the backfield. 4 receivers to the far side, the wide side of the field left.
Man-to-man coverage down here at the bottom of the screen.
Chiefs coming on a blitz. Here's a pass by Long over the middle, and it's knocked down. C.J. Wilson. Yeah, the pass was behind the intended receiver. They were looking for Verasso coming in over the middle, and C.J. jumped the route, knocked the pass down. And that'll bring up third down and 6.
Yeah, nice play there by C.J. as the ball. It looked like the ball was thrown behind him. I think the receiver got a hand on it just to, deflect help C.J. pick it off, but sets up a big third down here, about 3rd and 6.
They've got a tight end right, 2 receivers to either side, 1 man in the backfield. Here come the Chiefs again on a blitz. It's a pitch back to Long. He'll pass near side and wide open at the 20 for a first down. This is the tight end, Messner. Messner breaks the tackle at the 5 and into the house. That was Maxton Messner, the tight end. They handed the ball off and then pitched it back to the quarterback, Long, who threw to the right side, and there was no one home defensively for Bellefontaine. And so Granville goes 33 yards for the score, makes it 7-6.
That play was kind of reminded me of the Michigan play against Ohio State last year.
Well, we talked before the game with one of the beat writers from Newark who covers the Granville Blue Aces. He says Coach Schrader's going to pick a couple trick plays out there, and they ran one right there into perfection for the score. And now it'll be the Thistle floor covering extra point. Noah Music is on for those honors, this to tie the game. The snap is back, the hold is down, the kick is up, and the kick is good. And with 6:15 to play here in quarter one, both teams score on their opening salvos and were knotted up on the Quest Federal Credit Union scoreboard. It's Bellefontaine 7, Granville 7, and we'll be back with more. You're listening to Bellefontaine Chieftains football on 107.3 The Drive. Back at Bolus Field, Granville and
Jennings
Bellefontaine
Farley and
now
Seeley
tied
funeral
7-7.
Home in
the Blue Aces go 7 plays, 70 yards on their first possession. Converted a couple third downs too, Brandon.
Yeah.
And now your Dairy Queen of Bellefontaine kickoff. Coming back Bellefontaine's way, Riley near back pedals will take it at the 1 yard line. Out over the 5, the 10. Over to the far side, through a hole, 20-yard line. Riley near with a burst of speed to the 40-yard line. He's near the midfield stripe. He's in some traffic now and gets bottled up and knocked out of bounds on the plus side of the 50. Riley near took it from his 1-yard line all the way across midfield to about the 46-yard line of the Blue Aces. What a return for Riley near.
I'm going to tell you what, if he keep, they keep going this route, Riley might have 1,000-yard total offense.
Well, he's got a 55-yard kick return, and he's got 55. 5 yards on his receiving already.
We're halfway through the first quarter.
Riley Neer, such an electric player for Bellefontaine. He has 95 catches on the season for over 1,600 yards and 20 touchdowns. And on first down for Bellefontaine, they're going to pitch it to Fogan. Fogan tries the short side. He's got a hole, 40-yard line. Chris Fogan still moving. He's near the first down marker, runs over a defender, lands on top of him for the first down at the 36-yard line, a gain of 10 for Chris Fogan. He ran with purpose on that play.
Yeah, Grant caught Granville on the blitz up the middle there. I think Granville thought they were going to try to zone read there, and the quick toss there by Tavian to Fogan, and he was able to pick up 10 yards for a first down.
Chris already has 4 carries for 28 yards. Could be a lot of offense tonight if these first 6 minutes is any indication. First and 10 Chieftains from the Granville 36. Moving right to left, it's going to be a draw play handoff. Fogan again. Fogan hit at the line of scrimmage and driven back. He got a couple out to the 34-yard line, but getting up from the bottom of the pile for Granville, Drew Vaholic. He's a senior linebacker, 6'2", 180. Second down and 8.
I think that was the first play. Bellefontaine hadn't gotten 5 yards or more on the play.
Chieftains, prolific on offense this season, averaging about 36 points a game. Well, guess what? Granville does about the same. They average 35. Two receivers left, another to the right for Tavian St. Clair. At 6'4", 220 pounds, he's back to throw it. Screen play, Fogan. Fogan ducks inside the block to the hashes and gets taken down. Maxton Messner, who just scored the touchdown for Granville out of his linebacker position here, makes the stop at the 31-yard line, a pickup of 3. Third down for the Chiefs.
Again, a little screen play there coming towards us. And, Granville's DB on that side did a nice job fighting off that block and keeping that for a minimal gain. Sets up a big third down and 5 here, but I think Bellefontaine's in no-man territory. They're probably 2 plays to get 5 yards.
Agreed with that. They almost drew him offside with a hard snap count.
Yeah.
Tavian going to go back up toward the line of scrimmage now. Change the play call from the sideline as it comes in. He's back there in the shotgun set. Awaits the snap and has it. Takes a throw left, rolls right. The room is open. He's going to tuck it to run. First down and more inside the 25, the 20, to the far side. He'll slide down at about the 12-yard line. Again, a smart run. Tavian St. Clair avoiding the hit. They'll mark him at the 14. That's a gain of 17 for Tavian St. Clair.
Yes, something that they didn't show last week and hasn't been. They haven't shown a lot of quarterback runs, Bellefontaine has, all season long. So, you know, Granville, I think, on that third down wasn't expecting that. But nice job by Tavian as he was able to escape the pocket as Granville did send a blitz up the middle and was able to escape it, get around the right side and pick up a first down.
Chiefs operate in the Elevate Chiropractic red zone from the 14-yard line, first and 10. Handoff up the middle. Harper Scott runs straight ahead all the way to the house. Touchdown for Harper Scott. He had the big run in the fourth quarter against London last week, and here he busts one straight up the middle through a big hole, and from 14 yards out, he scores it for the seventh time this season, and the Chieftains take the lead back. It's 13-7.
Yeah, there's a lot of offense in this game tonight. Not much defense so far going in the first quarter, but, you know, nice play there by Harper as he was able to find daylight. Went in untouched, actually. Was able to find daylight and 14 yards out, find pay dirt.
Alex Crable with another Fissile Floor Covering extra point. Fissile Floor Covering, a reputation you can stand on. The kick is good. And with 3:34 to play here in the first quarter, your score on the Quest Federal Credit Union scoreboard, it's Bellefontaine 14 and Granville 7. We'll step aside. You're listening to Bellefontaine Chieftains football on 107.3 The Drive.
Jennings Farley and Seely Funeral Home and Crematory in Highland Memorial Cemetery, your local funeral service provider, can handle all of you and your loved ones' funeral service wishes, wants, and needs inclusively at one convenient location. We may also travel to you or your loved one's local cemetery to honor your burial wishes there. Jennings Farley Seely Funeral Home and Crematory in Highland Memorial Cemetery, conveniently located on US 68 just north of the Green Hills community.
Pizza Hut. You can try, but you can't out-pizza the Hut with classics like Meat Lovers, original stuffed crust, and their signature wings, pasta, and desserts. Order online or on the mobile app for carryout, curbside, or delivery. Pizza Hut of Bellefontaine. No one out-pizzas the Hut.
Bellefontaine Chieftains football brought to you by Patriots Attic. Lock it, load it, love it with Patriots Attic in Huntsville, your Logan County Firearms headquarters. Chiefs come right back with a touchdown drive set up by Riley Neer's big 55-yard kick return. They go 46 yards on the drive. Harper Scott caps it with the touchdown run. Now your Dairy Queen of Bellefontaine kickoff, and here comes Jacob Culver.
He's
out over
lane.
The middle, 25 Ooh. To the 26-yard line, and out to the 29-yard line, where Spencer Stolle makes this out. Looked like he almost broke it.
Yeah, Spencer did a nice job of getting from behind, because if he don't make that tackle, I think he's still running.
So, back and forth we go. And well, what has been an
quarter.
Arena football-like game here
yeah.
so far, Brandon?
Yeah, it has been.
Lots of offense on both sides.
Yeah.
3:28 to play here, first quarter. Chiefs 14, Granville 7. And now the Blue Aces will try to respond from their own 29-yard line. Beckett Long has two guys in the backfield with him. Look at this weird formation. And it's going to be a hand keeper. And with those two men helping to block, he tries to sweep the far side. And the Chiefs spring him out. And a good tackle made over there for Bellefontaine. And that was going to be Harper Scott on the stop. The man who just scored the touchdown for the Chiefs. Only a pickup of two for Beckett Long.
Yep. A score to keep an eye on. Bloom Carroll's up 7-0 on Bishop Watterson.
Okay, look at that. The winner here plays the winner there in the regional finals next week in
yep.
Region 11. Another score we're watching on the Quest Federal Credit Union scoreboard tonight, the Shawnee Braves.
Yep.
Also repping the CBC, the lone other standing team in the conference. They're beating Wyoming early tonight, 6-0. Long wants to throw. He's in trouble. Tries to escape the pocket. He gets hit as he gets to the line of scrimmage and got his bell rung by Bellefontaine's Harper Scott, and you also had Carter Caudill in there, and they both got him. A gain of one on the play to avoid a sack, and it'll bring up third down here for Granville. They need seven. They converted a pair of third downs on their first drive. 2:22 to play here, first quarter. Chieftains lead it 14-7. Noah Music comes in with the play call for the Blue Aces, and he lines up next to the quarterback, Beckett Long, 5 yards behind the line of scrimmage. A tight end right, two receivers right. Here's Long looking to throw right. He's out of the pocket. He rolls up to the front of the line of scrimmage and now will try to run for it.
First
he got popped out of bounds near the marker. tackle made by Jaden Temple, but he got the 6. He got the 41, in fact, yeah. And a gain of 9 to move the chain.
Very nimble quarterback there as he was able to. Chiefs had him dead in the rights, you know, dead in the water, and he was able to squirt, get out of there and, you know, pick up the necessary yardage and 1 to move the sticks for Granville.
Well, when Kyle Kirby got hurt in week 9, Beckett Long becomes the main rushing attack mm-hmm. for the Blue Aces from the quarterback position. He showed his prowess there. A heady quarterback who knew when to escape the pocket and knew where the sticks were. Chiefs come on a blitz. They don't get there. Pass down the near sideline. It's caught down the sideline, and going for a touchdown is Jacob Culver. He was one-on-one with Caden Snap, hauled it in at the 25-yard line and took it to the house. Oh, my goodness, from 59 yards out, they go over the top and make it a 14-13 game.
Like I said, it's, they're playing each other. I mean, they have the same offense. When I seen that on film earlier in the week, I'm like, oh, my gosh, this is like Bellefontaine playing Bellefontaine.
Beckett Long is 5 for 7 here in the first quarter, 124 yards and 2 touchdowns. Caden Snap was there.
He fell.
But he tripped, didn't he?
Yeah, he fell.
And now your Fissile floor covering point after. It's a bad snap picked up by the holder. The holder's in big-time trouble. He'll heave it to the end zone.
Oh,
it's caught!
Oh, my
it's
gosh.
Caught! Culver caught it! And somehow the quarterback, Beckett Long, who was the holder, got away from Harper Scott about the 20-yard line. Whirled around and found Culver open on the near side for a 2-pointer, and Granville leads. Granville leads with the 2-point conversion. And with 1:49 to play here in the first quarter, your score on the Quest Federal Credit Union scoreboard is Granville 15 and Bellefontaine 14.
Are you
we'll step
for
aside.
A place to tan or do your laundry? Buckeye Wash and Tan has you covered. Their goal is to provide you the highest level service and products in a clean and friendly environment at an affordable price. Their laundry facility is fast, reliable, and saves you time. Full service will take care of the laundry for you. There's always an attendant on duty. Ohio weather can be dreary at times. Getting a tan helps you feel good all year long, regardless of the weather. They provide clean and well-maintained beds to help you feel your best. Let Buckeye Wash and Tan brighten your clothes and your day.
We're back here in London. Granville on a busted play on the 2-point conversion. Scores it and now leads it 15-14.
On a busted play. How about that? That's crazy.
1:49 to play, first quarter. Your Dairy Queen of Bellefontaine kickoff. It's an onside kick attempt by Granville.
Oh, they're offsides.
And they were offside.
Yeah, they were offsides.
They came across the 40-yard line.
It was close.
Before,
but I think he was.
Yeah, before the kicker did.
Yeah.
So it's going to be our very first Bellefontaine Police Department penalty of the night. They tried an onside kick. A little dribbler, and it was almost executed to perfection.
It was, but I think the number was, I think number 11, was it? Yeah, the big.
Leland Durham.
Yeah, I think he was offside, or he was offside, and it was close, though, man. And that Granville fans don't like it.
The Chiefs get a break.
Yeah, they do. They caught a huge one.
And Bellefontaine Police Department reminds you, do not text and drive. Tonight's game brought to you by the Jennings, Farley, and Seeley Funeral Home and Crematory and the Highland Memorial Cemetery on U.S. 68, just north of the Green Hills community. Brandon, each team's had the ball twice. Each team has scored twice. And Granville has the lead thanks to that 2-point conversion. Bodie Shopes will try to kick it again. This time the Chiefs are ready for a potential onside kick. It's a pooch kick into no man's land. It's going to be fumbled and muffed by the Chiefs. I think Jaden Temple covered it up at the 43-yard line. He dropped it initially at the 40 and then fell on it. His aces were flying around him to try to get after that ball as well.
Anything to keep the ball out of right. They're trying everything to keep the ball out of Riley Neer's hands right now.
Yeah, I don't think we'll see another kick deep to Riley.
Oh, you're
going to
see all type of different things now.
Riley had a big 55-yard return last time.
Yeah.
Well, Bellefontaine does have beautiful field position again, though. They start at their own 44-yard line approaching midfield. 1:44 to play here, first quarter. Granville now with the 15-14 lead. Three receivers right side for the Chiefs, another to the near side left. It's going to be a pitch to Fogan. Fogan's going to try the right side. Blows right through the line of scrimmage and ahead across midfield to about the 49-yard line, and a good run for Mr. Fogan. They'll put it right on the midfield stripe for a gain of six.
You know, Fogan's running the ball real hard as he hits that hole. You know, he had a defender that was trailing him, looked like he was going to catch him from behind, but Fogan has that second gear and was able to pick up 7 yards for Bell, or 6 yards, I'm saying. I think it's closer to seven. Sets up a second and four for Bell Fountain.
C.J. Wilson goes wide to the right, to the near side left, Riley Near. Look how far off the defender's playing, off 10 yards against Riley Near. My goodness.
Yeah, 11 yards.
It'll be Tavian taking the shotgun snap. He's going to hand it to Fogan. Runs on the red L here at London High School at midfield for a first down. Right between the hashes and between the tackles to the 44-yard line of the Blue Aces. A gain of six. Move the sticks for the Chiefs. We're under a minute to play first quarter. Granville 15, Bellefontaine 14. Hayden Mann's in as the H-back on the right side. Wilson lines up wide to the near side left. They've got receivers bunched near the formation over to the far side right. On first down, it's going to be another handoff to Fogan. Tries to sweep that far side. Gets to the numbers, makes his cut. He's ahead across the 40, inside the 40 to the 36-yard line. Fogan got eight more yards. And the Chieftains continue to do a nice job of mixing run and pass here, Brandon. It's ten rushes to just four passes here for the play selection.
Yeah, and you've seen a lot of their Bellefontaine runs have come, the majority of them have come to the outside, in the outside zones to Fogan as he's been able to get the corner, and those offensive linemen have been able to pull and seal that edge.
The first quarter comes to a close with your score on the Quest Federal Credit Union scoreboard. Granville 15, Bellefontaine 14. We'll step aside. You're listening to Bellefontaine Chieftains football on 107.3 The Drive.
Attention Fat Boys Pizza and Ice Cream customers, it's that time again, it's football time. Get your Fat Boys fix before the game, or order while the game's going on. We're open till 10. We have hot pizzas, subs, and salads. 592 Fats.
Hi everybody, this is Dr. Jacob from Elevate Chiropractic, Bellefontaine's newest chiropractic clinic. Aren't you tired of being in pain and not living life to your fullest? Chiropractic care not only relieves pain, but more importantly, it helps your body handle stress better in the long term. We tailor every adjustment specific to you with the help of our in-house digital x-ray suite, along with corrective stretches and exercises. It's time to take back control of your own health today. Visit ElevateChiroCare.com or call 937-210-5525 to schedule now.
Back at Bolus Field in London, Dave Bezusko, Brandon Stockton with you, Lou Vito. We've got Gary Kauffman, Evan Cook back at the studios. Glad you're with us tonight for Chieftains football here on 107.3 The Drive. We're also streaming video at nfhsnetwork.com, nfhsnetwork.com. We'll get it. It's an alphabet soup here. On first down, it's a handoff, Harper Scott. Harper into the line, left side, gets pinballed around to about the 33-yard line for a gain of three. Anyway, you can go watch this game live now. It will also be up at Peak of Ohio TV tomorrow morning. Peak of Ohio TV and on YouTube tomorrow to watch the replay. We're glad you're with us here on the broadcast tonight as the Chieftains and Blue Aces rematch from a year ago. It's a 15-14 lead for the Blue Aces. Second down and seven, Bellefontaine. At the Blue Aces 33-yard line, Chiefs now move left to right here in quarter two. Blue Aces bring some linebackers, and here they come on a blitz. Pass far side and incomplete. A rare miss throw by Tavian St. Clair, wide open. C.J. Wilson over on that far side, and they do not connect, bringing up third down and about seven.
Well, Granville brought a pressure off the edge, and I think Tavian wanted to, do a sprint draw out there and wasn't able to get the corner, and we just threw it off his back foot and was, you know, was pass fell incomplete. It sets up a second and 10 for Bellefontaine. They've been able to run the ball successful on first down, so I think you're going to see Bellefontaine go back to the ground here.
Second down and 10, Bellefontaine. Hand off Fogan. Fogan, stutter step move through the hole. Has another move at the 30-yard line
touchdown.
To the 25, 20, 15, 10, 5, and touchdown. And Chris Fogan zigging and zagging his way from 33 yards out. He scores it, and the Chieftains are back in front. It's 20-15. How about that? Fogan has 83 yards rushing already tonight. And the Chiefs have three touchdowns in three possessions. And now an Alex Crable extra point brought to you by Fissile Floor Covering. Fissile Floor Covering, a reputation that you can stand on. Boy will snap it back to Near. Near puts it on the floor. And there's your boot through the uprights by Crable. And with 11:15 to play before halftime, it is Bellefontaine 21 and Granville 15. We'll step aside. You're listening to Bellefontaine Chieftains football on 107.3 The Drive.
Come to the pizza shop where all the locals know where to go. Jack and Doe's, a family tradition for over 50 years. Started by the Valentine family in the late 60s, it's now operated by the third generation. They were taught how to make delicious, quality pizza, subs, chicken, and more. Jack and Doe's, home of the original large sheet pizza. Visit their Facebook page or one of their three locations for dine-in, delivery, or carry-out in Kenton, Russell's Point, or Urbana. Jack and Doe's, the tradition lives on.
Back here at London's Bolus Field, Brandon, neither team's shown an ability to stop the other. Five offensive possessions, five touchdowns so far. The Chiefs have a 21-15 lead.
Yeah, that play, go back to the Fogan touchdown, was, you know, looked like he was going to be stopped for a minimal game, but he was able to cut, the cutback lane was there, and he spotted it and was able to find daylight and find pay dirt.
This is going to be a kickoff from Dairy Queen of Bellefontaine, and here comes Jacob Culver. Culver coming up the field across the 30, all the way out to about the 32-yard line before Caden Snap gets to him. But Culver with a terrific run there. And now you have a Granville football. And let's see if the Chiefs defense can settle in here.
Well, I think it's, you know, going back to, you know, watching both offenses and watching both defenses, I think what, you know, what Granville is doing is they're leaving their, you know, they're trying to stop the pass, and they're not able to do that. So, you know, that's opened up running lanes for Fogan. And if you're Bellefontaine, you know, you're scared of the quarterback, but you're also scared of, you know, he's been pinpoint accuracy on a lot of his throws.
On first down here is a pass to the far side. This is going to be Culver again, but he got wrapped up on the wide receiver screen. The Chiefs are all over it. Again, a play the Chiefs run in practice a lot. They know how to cover that. And it was Harper Scott over there, and it was also C.J. Wilson.
It was Kalen Oregon that made that
tackle. Kalen Oregon, okay.
Yep.
After a minimal gain, they got one. It'll be second down and 9. Four receivers come wide to the near side left. One receiver to the far side right for the quarterback, Beckett Long, who was 6 of 8 passing for 125 yards and 2 touchdowns. He awaits the shotgun snap. Will fire to the near side. This is Verasso. They set up a double
wide
pass.
Open.
Wide open down the near sideline. That's Jaeger. Waits for the ball and makes the catch. He had to stop and wait for the ball that was underthrown, but they'll take it. It's a big gainer all the way down to the Bellefontaine 45-yard line as Coach Schroeder goes to his bag of tricks again.
You've seen that. That's the second time we've seen that play ran against Bellefontaine. As you remember, Coldwater ran that earlier on in the season. So, you know, if you're Bellefontaine and you're safety on that, you can't let that happen. He crossed your face. You got to run with him.
And so with another trick play, the double pass, Granville's got it in Bellefontaine territory at the 45-yard line. Long wants to throw again to the near side, hits his receiver. Knocked out of bounds by Chris Fogan at the 34-yard line. That's Verasso on the catch. Another first down as they get 11 on that play.
Mm-hmm.
A quick pass to the near side that time.
Yeah, just a little 10-yard out. You know, Fogan playing about 11 yards off of him. And as soon as the ball was snapped, Fogan bailed on him, and he was picked up. You know, one. I think I'm assuming number one is Granville's best receiver. So if they're giving him that kind of kind of cushion well, on the outside.
Verasso has 60 catches coming in. Jacob Culver, who had the long touchdown, 54 passes coming in. So they're about even. Yeah. This is a quarterback keeper. Long keeps the ball and runs it straight ahead down the half to the 31-yard line. And in the middle of the pile for Bellefontaine, they had Carter Caudill. They had Hayden Manns in there. It'll be second down and seven.
You know, Bellefontaine's done a nice job on the interior front of stopping the quarterback dive. That it looks like that's Granville's go-to running play. And, you know, talking to the guys from Newark on the radio station beside us, they said that he was able to – he calls his own plays. So, you know, that's pretty high football IQ.
9:20 to play before halftime. Chiefs lead it 21-15. Here's a slant pass over the middle. This is caught by Yeager. Yeager can't get away from the defender at the 25-yard line. And that'll be a play of about six.
So about,
it'll be third and about one.
Yeah, it's going to be a short one.
And so you have the football belonging to Granville at the 25-yard line going in. They've got it third down and one. They are 3-for-3 on third down tonight. They're going to rush in a player from the sideline, Dylan Lane, team captain.
He was chilling.
Was he chilling?
Yeah, he was chilling.
He was watching video over here. They got a tent with a big 60-inch TV. They're actually showing game film to players who were not playing. This time they load the box with blockers. It's a quarterback. Draw the ball loose. He lost the ball. Beckett Long lost it, and the Chiefs come away with it. Harper Scott's got the football, and Bellefontaine turns away the Blue Aces with another big turnover. The Chiefs have 21 takeaways on the season, make it 22. They had two big ones a week ago on this very field, and that turned the game in the second half. And here's the first defensive stop of this night. It comes with 8:27 to play before half. Chiefs get the ball back, leading 21-15.
Well, I think, you know, Granville, to begin that play was a little miscombobulated, running players onto the field. And I didn't know what the play clock was at, but, I mean, if I'm that coach, big game like this, you got to take a timeout.
Chiefs on their first offensive play. Give to Fogan. He tries to run through the middle but got held up at the line of scrimmage and down at the 28-yard line. Good tackle right in the middle of the pile that time for Granville. And once the player turns this way, I can tell you who it was. It was number 50, Cooper Phillips, their middle linebacker. Second down and seven.
Yeah.
Boy, that's a big play for the Chiefs.
That was a big play for Bellefontaine.
Needed something positive to happen defensively, and it did. They bunch the formation to the Chiefs. Extra blockers up front. Fake handoff. Pass over the middle. It's incomplete. Hit him right on the hands, and that was going to be C.J. Wilson, who couldn't come away with it as he was cutting across the far side hash. An unusual drop from C.J. Wilson brings up third down and seven.
Great route by C.J. as he was able to get in front of the defender. And, you know, if that ball's thrown, you know, any better, I don't know if he could throw that ball any better because that ball was put right there. He's still running. He might score a touchdown.
Tavian, 4 of 6 for 66 yards and a score. Third down and seven here for the Chiefs at the 29-yard line. Tavian takes the shotgun snap. Pass near side. Riley Near makes the catch. Shake and bake Mook at the 40. 45-yard line, 50. Another spin move at the 45 and finally brought down from behind in Blue Aces territory at the 43-yard line. Just a timing route to the near side. St. Clair to Near, who then got away with some yards after catch.
Dude, that ball was thrown right. He wasn't even out of his break yet. And when he turned out of his break, that ball was right on him. I think Riley might have turned his ankle on that play because he's limping off to the side.
Uh-oh.
Yeah.
28 yards on the pass play for St. Clair to Near, but maybe bigger. Riley's going off to that far side of the field. We will watch that closely.
Mm-hmm.
In the meantime, first and 10, Bellefontaine at the Blue Aces 43-yard line. Shotgun snap, handoff Fogan. Chris tries the left side. Turns at the hash upfield. He goes inside the 40 to the 38-yard line. Yeah, we'll give him six. It'll be second down and four. Chris Fogan's already approaching 100 yards tonight, Brandon.
He's actually been, you know, the focal point of Bellefontaine's offense, him and Riley tonight. And, you know, sprinkle in Harper Scott. You know, they've done a nice job. Bellefontaine has is, you know, running that. Here in the last couple of weeks, we've seen that two-back system with Harper and Fogan. And Caden, it seems to be working for the Chiefs.
Caden Folk is into the ball game. He is on the edge of the line on the right side. Riley Near back into the game. Riley Near catches the pass on the near side. Gets away from the defender. Miss another stutter step move. Look at the shake and bakes down the sideline inside the 25 to the 23-yard line. I do like shake and bake with my chicken.
I bet you do.
That's just why I like that term. And we like watching Riley Near make those dance moves down the sideline. He got 14 yards, Riley Near. I think his ankle's just fine after watching that. That was Riley's fourth catch of the night, and the Chiefs have it at the 22-yard line of the Blue Aces.
And there was a penalty on Bellefontaine. Sideline warning.
Okay. Clock at 6:15 and counting before halftime. Bellefontaine 21, Granville 15. Chiefs with a trio of receivers in a triangle to the edge of the line left. It's going to be a handoff to Fogan. Those guys are all blockers. They open a hole, and Fogan runs through it down to the 16-yard line. He got about six, Chris Fogan. And the Chieftains continue to move the football. They are into the Elevate Chiropractic red zone. Elevate and take control of your health with Bellefontaine's newest chiropractic clinic. Visit ElevateChiroCare.com.
And what's big here for Bellefontaine is going, you know, here early or, you know, halfway through the second quarter is that the success that they've had on first down running the football with Fogan and Harper Scott.
Lets you do just about anything in the playbook here on second and short. This is going to be a draw play handoff Fogan, and that time he's hit at the line and driven back. Probably lost a yard or two that time as there were a pair of Blue Aces in there to make that stop. And it's going to bring up a third down play for the Chiefs. That's the first negative offensive play of the night for Bellefontaine, which has not had a penalty whistled against them and no negative yardage plays. Now it's third down and five for the Chiefs. They are 2 for 2 on third downs tonight. And from the Granville 17, they put two wide to either side.
Yeah, Riley in a slot against the safety. And he comes in motion.
Riley in motion, and this is going to be quarterback keeper. No, yep, Tavian St. Clair gets pinballed down at the 16-yard line. The hole closed quickly. He got knocked down by Cooper Phillips. Going to bring up an interesting fourth down play call for Coach Brown. They're probably too far to try a field goal, I would envision. You go for it here on fourth and five.
Here, if I'm Coach, with 4 minutes left to go in the half, you're up six. You know, maybe the back shoulder, their favorite play is the back shoulder or the outs on the outside, but they got Riley in a slot. I like this matchup here.
Here we go on fourth down and five. St. Clair gonna turn to the sideline. They've got Folk and Near wide left, near side right. Yeah. You got Fogan and CJ. It will be a timeout. Timeout for the Chieftains. We'll keep it here with 4:03 to play here in the first half. Your score is 21-15 in favor of Bellefontaine. Tonight's game brought to you by Buckeye Washington, your full-service laundromat and tanning salon. Also by Jack and Doe's Pizza, home of the original sheet pizza. Well, both teams scored on their first two possessions, then Bellefontaine scored on their third, turned away Granville, so you got a chance to go up two scores here, but you got to convert on fourth down.
Yeah, this is for both teams, for Bellefontaine's offense, this is a big play because here's the thing, if you convert here, on possibility go up two scores before half because Granville gets the ball coming out of halftime. So if you're Bellefontaine, you kind of want to convert. Best play that you know that's going to get you 6 yards or 5 yards, whatever it is, and, you know, try to go up two scores to try to put the pressure right back on Granville's offense.
They'll put three receivers to the far side left. Football on the right side hash. That's the near side. C.J. Wilson wide to the right.
See a quick out here to the top of the field going towards Bellefontaine sidelines.
Hayden Mann's in the backfield with Tavian St. Clair. He takes the shotgun snap. He rolls to his left. Pressure's coming. He throws it over the middle. Wide open and unable to juggle and bring it in is Chris Fogan. The ball thrown behind him. He tried to bat it to himself as he was crossing the goal line and couldn't do it as he fell to the turf. It's a turnover on downs, and the ball will go back to
Granville. He was wide open. I mean, the only thing you got to do is just, throw that ball on the line. It's wide open. But what a play. What a big stand there for Granville going, you know, to keep Bellefontaine out of the end zone, possibly going up two scores there.
So now both teams have made a stop.
Yeah. And going forward towards the end, in the fourth quarter, that might come down the way these two teams are playing here tonight.
3:58 to play before halftime. Catch your breath for a minute. It's 21-15 in favor of Bellefontaine. Granville's going to come back out the other way. Navy blue tops, white pants, silver helmets. They move right to left. Chieftains do not come on a blitz. Handoff up the middle. It's a flag, and it whistles the play dead. Flags and whistles. Yep, false start against the Blue Aces. It's the second Bellefontaine Police Department penalty of the night. Tonight's game brought to you by Iron City Sports Bar on South Main Street in Bellefontaine. For Logan County's best burgers and wings, it's Iron City Sports Bar. I understand they're streaming the game there video-wise tonight at Iron City Sports Bar. You could be video streaming the game too. NFHSnetwork.com, NFHSnetwork.com if you want to watch it right now, and then you can watch it tomorrow for free on PeakofOhioTV.com. Almost a pick to the near side instead. Verasso makes the catch. He's weaving his way up the near side, numbers across the 20, out to about the 21-yard line. He got about six on that play, and it'll bring up second and nine.
Yeah, he got more than that. I think it's going to be about second and six as he was able to get the penalty yardage back, plus another 4 yards. But Riley Neer was in perfect position to make that tackle. I thought he was going to pick it off.
I thought he was too. He went for the ball.
Yeah, he did.
And that was a wise move. You could have had a pick six there.
Yeah.
Second down and six from the 21-yard line.
I think we'll see a quarterback sweep or no. Nope.
Beckett wants to throw. Beckett long, fast as far sideline, and that one's knocked away. Good Kalen Ogan with Oregon with some terrific defense against Jacob Culver on that far side. Batted the pass with his right arm as he fronted the receiver to make that play. And it brings up third down now and six for Granville. This will be another big stop. We've not had a three and out on either side tonight.
We have not.
And with the field position you have,
this
could be big.
Yeah, it could be huge.
Chiefs trying to get off the field on defense here.
It's third and six.
They put four receivers all to the far side, bunched up. That's tough to cover over there. You don't know where they're going to break out of it. Pass over the middle. It's a first down. Caught out to the 30-yard line. They'll spot at the 29. The receiver making the catch was Mr. Culver. And so Beckett Long continues his hot start. He is now 10 of 13 passing. And the Blue Aces move the sticks again on the third down. And now a pass over the middle, incomplete.
He had a pick.
Carter Caudill almost picked one off. He had a shot at that one.
He sure did. And, you know, Granville went a little fast there and caught Bellefontaine off guard. And they actually had a defensive lineman, at, you know, 5 yards off the ball in pass coverage. That's a lineman's dreams of being pass coverage.
Under 3 minutes to go before halftime. You ever pick off a pass, Brandon?
I couldn't catch the ball. And
man in motion to the near side. Here's a pass for Beckett Long again. He's going to heave it down the near side on a wheel route. It's intercepted as the Chiefs get back Chris Fogan backpedaling with the receiver, Maxton Messner, and he intercepted it. Fogan with the INT, and the Chiefs come up with back-to-back turnovers. They'll have the ball with plenty of time and three timeouts.
That was a bad throw by that quarterback. Terrible throw.
He underthrew it.
Not only that, he threw it into double coverage.
Well, the Chiefs have a shot here. They've got the ball at their own 40-yard line. And
2:51 left. They got two timeouts left. Enough time for the Chieftain offense to find pay dirt.
Bellefontaine with a 21-15 lead, a chance to go up two scores before halftime. Three receivers in a triangle to the far side left. C.J. Wilson wide to the right. This is going to be a screen set up for Riley Neer with those receivers blocking. He tries to jump out of a tackle and can't do it at the 41-yard line. Good coverage that time by the Blue Aces. They limit it to a yard.
Yeah, I think they defended that a little bit differently as, you know, when you see when I think they changed their defense up a little bit too. They were in a four-man front. Now they switched to a three-man, and they're able to, I think it's a 3-5-3. Yeah, it's a 3-5-3.
Second down and nine, football at the 41-yard line. St. Clair takes the snap, rolls to his right, throws on the run, fires it to the near side, caught. Riley Neer catches it and then just ducks out of bounds. First down across midfield to the 47-yard line. That's an easy pitch and catch.
Oh, it is, especially when your DBs are playing that far off of you. I, you know, that's all night.
12 yards on the pickup, And I say it's easy. They make it look easy. We'll put it that way,
yeah,
huh?
Well, it is. I mean, when the DB's playing that far off of you and you got a quarterback that has an arm like Tavian does, and, you know, the work that him and Riley has put in over the summer and throughout this whole season, yeah, it is easy work.
Riley Neer has six catches, 110 yards already here in the first half. Clock at 2:15 to play before halftime. Chiefs lead it 21-15. They've got it at the Granville 47-yard line, first and 10. Handoff Fogan tries the left side. He's got a blocker. He follows Owen Larrison through the hole and inside the 40. They'll spot it at the 40. A gain of seven more yards for Chris Fogan. He eclipses the 100-yard mark now on the ball game. And so the Chiefs in one half have a 100-yard rusher and a 100-yard receiver and a 100-yard passer.
Yeah, it makes life a little bit easier. Makes play calling that a lot easier, I can tell you that.
Riley Neer in a near side slot. Zane Tevis, the 4.0 honor roll student, wide to the right here. Far side left, it's C.J. Wilson. On second down and three, it's a low snap and a whistle and flag, and they're going to be a false start.
Yeah, it's going to be a snap infraction. I think, I don't know what the center was, or I think the center went on his own count there as he was the only one that snapped the ball, and Tavian wasn't even ready for it, so.
Brody Boy's done a nice job down
there
all season long. He gets called for this one, though. The first Bellefontaine Police Department penalty of the night against the Chiefs. Puts it back at the 45-yard line. Clock at 1:35 to play before halftime. It's rolling. Chiefs lead 21-15, looking for more points. It's second down and eight at the Granville 45-yard line. Granville showing a blitz. Fake handoff, pass over the middle. It's caught. No, it's dropped. C.J. Wilson had it and lost it at the 35-yard line. Would have been a first down.
Yep.
C.J. That's with two, his second drop.
Yeah, yeah. Second drop, you know, I think it's just kind of, he just needs to relax a little bit. You know, he gets hard on himself, but, you know, that ball, again, put right where he needed to be, and, you know, he just didn't come up with the catch. Sets up a third down and eight for Bellefontaine. And, again, if you're Granville, and, you know, you got an opportunity to stomp them here, is that, you know.
Granville fans making all kinds of noise, stomping on the bleachers, waving and ringing cowbells. It's third down and eight. Here's the snap to Tavian. He wants to roll right, throws back over the middle, coming right for the ball, making the catch. Riley Neer in traffic. He's down at the 36-yard line. It's a first down. Riley came back to the football, saw his quarterback was in trouble, and fought through defenders to get that position to make that play.
That's a heck of a catch. I almost cussed on the radio, sorry. But
from the 35-yard line, clock at 105 and counting before halftime. Chiefs still have all three timeouts. They lead 21-15. High snap. St. Clair hauls it down. Rolls to his left. He's in trouble. Fakes the throw. Now does throw and incomplete. He had defenders breathing down his back as he rolled all the way out beyond the numbers and just tossed it to a receiver on the sideline out of bounds. We're second down and 10.
Just, you know, live the play another day. You know, don't try to force anything, but you know, Granville's taking chances here. You know, they're bringing the pressure, you know, the last couple plays, and I think they're going to try to, you know, limit Bellefontaine. If you can, you try to limit their, you know, their yardage here on second down and 10.
Two receivers wide to either side, football between the hashes, right in the middle of the field. St. Clair takes the shotgun snap, fires the ball over the middle. That ball is incomplete. Passed Riley Neer behind him, and then there were two defenders, and then Zane Tevis. It went through all four players and incomplete to the turf, and now it's going to be third down and 10.
Yeah, another blitz there by Granville. They were able to if you're Bellefontaine, I'd like to see them. You see Granville, you know, blitzing the last couple plays. You know, get the young man out on the perimeter, give him a run pass option as he was able to, you know, early on in the first quarter, and see what happens on his third down play.
Third and 10 for the Chieftains at the Granville 35-yard line. Chiefs lead 21-15. 50 seconds to play before halftime. St. Clair takes the snap. He's got time this time. Waits for a receiver opening up down the field all the way to the end zone, looking for Riley Neer. Overthrew him. There was double coverage that time, and it's going to bring up fourth down. Riley was hoping for a flag down there, but he doesn't get a holding call, and it'll bring up fourth down and 10 for the Chiefs.
Yeah, if you're Bellefontaine, you're kind of in no man's land here. You could punt them and try to pin them deep.
My concern would be, is this good enough field position for Granville to go back the other way?
I don't know.
They have two timeouts. Yeah, there's 43 seconds.
Like I said, you're kind of in no man's land. Play clock's running down to 19. Looks like Bellefontaine is going to go for it here.
the ball at the 35-yard line. They come out might with the offense.
Might try to draw them off sides and make the fourth down play a little bit more convertible.
Play clock down to six. St. Clair in the shotgun. Two receivers right, two receivers left. He's going to throw it. Throws it right side. Timing route incomplete. Looking for Riley Neer. And no go on that. And so Blue Aces turn the Chiefs aside with turnovers on downs on back-to-back possessions. And now it'll be Granville football with 40 seconds left.
And three timeouts left.
Two. They have two timeouts left.
Sorry.
And they're at their own 35, trailing by six. Granville will get the ball to start the second half. I have a feeling Coach Schroeder and company are going to take some shots. High school football brought to you by Saucy Sows, which reminds you, let's get saucy, and also by Fazoli's of Bellefontaine, where they have great Italian food. All right, Granville football, they'll spread the field. Three receivers wide, near side left, and one to the far side right. Beckett Long rolling left, looking to throw across his body, hits Verasso at the 40. He's wrestled out of bounds by Kalen Organ at the 42-yard line. He got seven.
Well, I'm telling you right now, you know, we've seen their field goal kicker warm up. And we're talking to the guys from the Newark radio station. What did they say his longest was, 49 yards?
Yeah, he's got some long ones, so they don't have to go that much farther to get into his range, maybe another 30 yards. Clock at 35 seconds. Two receivers to either side. Ball will be snapped from the left hash. Long wants to throw it left side again. Verasso catches it. Back pedals his way out of bounds to stop the clock to the 47-yard line. That was an easy play for five. And that took all of 3 seconds off the clock. And it's going to be first down and 10 for the Blue Aces as they near midfield. Clock at the 47-yard line. 32 ticks left. They have two timeouts, so they can attack the middle of the field.
Mm-hmm.
They probably need about 25 more yards to get in the kicker's range. Long wants to throw it to the near side. Catch is made again. Verasso ducks out of bounds after a pickup of nine to the 44-yard line of the Chiefs.
Yeah, they're playing that soft zone on the outside, and, you know, Granville sees it, and they're just able to, you know, pick their poison. I think they're I hope they're not setting something up here with 29 seconds left to go in the game or in the half. Is a double move. You're going to see Bellefontaine's DBs pull, you know, try to cheat up, and you got to be ready for that double move.
Chiefs coming on a blitz. This is going to be all trouble in the backfield, and a nice play by Jaden Temple, who disrupted that by coming off the left side edge of the offensive line, flying into the backfield. Beckett Long goes down with a Dairy Queen Blizzard blitz back at the 47-yard line. That'll be stopping the clock for a timeout, Granville, and some disruption there.
Yeah, I didn't think. Well, they had to set up the double move.
We're going to take a timeout quickly before halftime. Timeout with the Chiefs leading 21-15 on 107.3 The Drive.
Looking to save money every month? Well, who isn't? With a Quest MasterCard, you can lock in a low fixed interest rate from 5.99 to 11.9% APR for qualified cardholders. You can even perform balance transfers from other high interest cards and save real money every month. Apply online today. Membership and credit score eligibility required. Quest Federal Credit Union. Explore the possibilities. NCUA insured. Equal opportunity lender.
Looking for a way to make your gun even more awesome? Come down to Patriot's Attic and get yourself a silencer. We take care of all the paperwork and fingerprints in-house, so the most stressful part for you is deciding which can to buy. The best part? When you buy a silencer at Patriot's Attic, you're free to take it out of jail and use it on our range whenever you want while you're waiting for that form to be approved. So make that wait time worth it and come see us on County Road 130 between Huntsville and Bellefontaine.
Out of the timeout, Beckett Long takes the snap for those Granville Blue Aces, and he runs the football straight ahead to the 40-yard line where he stops the clock momentarily, and then the Granville Blue Aces call their final timeout as they now actually still have one left, Brandon. They have one left.
Okay.
And it's going to be first and 10 Blue Aces with 20 seconds left here before halftime. Bellefontaine with a 21-15 lead. We've hit the top of the hour. You're listening to WPKO Radio HD2 in Bellefontaine. 107.3 The Drive. Dave Bezusko and Brandon Stockton with you here. Evan Cook back at the studios. We've got Lou Vito and Gary Kauffman with us as they are filming the video for us that you'll be able to see for free tomorrow at peakofohiotv.com. You'll see the game in its entirety at that time, or you can log on to nfhsnetwork.com right now and watch it live for a fee. The NFHS Network is a statewide network of all sorts of broadcasts and sports throughout the state. And here on the first down play, a pass over the middle and incomplete as the Chiefs almost got into the backfield for a sack. Hayden Manns was getting things done in that backfield for the Chiefs again. It's going to bring up second down and 10. Clock down to 16 seconds here in the half.
Yeah, Hayden did put a nice rip move on that defensive or offensive tackle over there. And was able to get in the face of the quarterback and create a pass that was low to the ground. And I think that pass was thrown on time and correctly. I think, you know, Buffon has a chance here for a pick.
Second down and 10. They have one timeout left. Fake handoff. This will be a pass down the near side wheel route. It's almost intercepted. They were looking for Messner. Jaden Temple was there, and Riley Neer came over and almost picked it off. Messner's no to get up, but he does peel himself off the turf and head back to the huddle. 12 seconds to play before halftime. Chiefs trying to have the Aces drive stall right here on third. They'll have the fourth down play, too, doubtless.
Well, see, what happens is that, you know, he's throwing in contested areas because Buffon's only rushing three, and they're still getting pressure with three guys up front. So he's thrown into, you know, the linebackers and safeties and corners, and it's not there's no threat there.
On third down, here come the Chiefs on a blitz again. Pass to the near side. Verasso makes the catch. He's outside the numbers, weaving his way to the 34. Tackle made by Riley Neer. He's down after a gain of six. 3 seconds to play. The timeout taken by Coach Schroeder. This is his last one. It brings up fourth down, and they will have either a 50-yard kick at this, or they will have a play where they'll have to try the Hail Mary. And if I were them, I'd try the Hail Mary. We saw that work on this very field at this very moment of the ball game last week.
I think they're going to go for it. I think they're going to try to kick this.
Now, their field goal kicker, Noah Musick, has a 49-yard field goal this season. Ball spotted at the 35. So depending on where they spot the ball, it would be about a 51, 52-yard field goal try. The wind is blowing across the field from the near side to the far side. And the quarterback is the holder. This is a fake field goal of some kind. The Chiefs aren't buying anything here. They're going to send some deep men all the way back. Safeties will the Chiefs around the 20 and 10-yard lines. And they are lining up to kick this field goal. They're going to put it down at the 41-yard line. So this is a 51-yard attempt for Noah Musick. The quarterback is the holder. Snap back, hold down. Kick up, and it's on its way. It's going to be short.
Yep.
Not even close. In fact, here come the Chieftains on a return,
you
can't do in high school ball. And so the play's whistled dead, and that is that. The first half comes to an end. A very entertaining first half of play. A first half, Brandon, that saw both teams score on their first two possessions.
Yep.
Chiefs got one more score, and then both teams did not score on their final two possessions of the half.
Yep.
Interesting.
I think it was just defense has finally settled in. And, you know, it's second half is going to be, I think, come down to, you know, who makes the biggest plays and who can stop who.
Well, 24
three
minutes
scores,
away.
Right?
Yeah.
Three scores, right?
24 minutes away to see who's going to the regional championship. Your score at halftime on the Quest Federal Credit Union scoreboard, it is Bellefontaine 21 and Granville 15. We will be coming back here after this break and coming back with a halftime show. You're listening to Bellefontaine Chieftains football on 107.3 The Drive.
At Easton Water, we're fully committed to fulfilling our promises to our customers. As a locally owned, staffed, and operated company, our reputation is critical, and we mean what we say. We want to be your trusted source for everything water. If recent changes in the market have left you high and dry when it comes to drinking water, water softeners, salt, or anything else to do with the water in your home or business, we're here for you and would love to be your trusted water partner. Visit EastonWater.com or give us a call and we'll get you added to our route.
see what a roof by Warren might look like on your home, please visit our website, roofsbywarren.com. And remember, we have over 30 years' experience in dealing with insurance.
When the time has come and your roof needs done, the name you can call is Warren. When it finally stops pouring, it's time to call Warren. Roofsbywarren.com.
Roofs by Warren. See us at roofsbywarren.com.
Here's an important reminder from Jacob's Auto Repair. While school's out for the holidays and the kids are home from college, it's a great time to make sure their cars are ready for the upcoming winter weather. Simple things like having the battery and tires checked, making sure the heater is warming, and the defroster is working properly. A good checkup for their cars can save the kids and you stress. The last thing you want is to have your child stranded in bad weather. Give Jacob's Auto Repair a call today and get on the schedule. 592-2233.
Hi, it's Liz at Bellefontaine's Comfort Inn, reminding you we offer your out-of-town guests a comfortable alternative. Available amenities include in-room microwave and fridge, complimentary breakfast, outdoor pool, and on-site lounge. And king rooms come with hot tubs. It really does beat crowding into your house, and we're pet-friendly too. Reservations are easy at choicehotels.com or call 937-599-5555. That's Bellefontaine's Comfort Inn.
The weekend should be for relaxing, and that means no cooking. Check out what's hot at Ron's Pizza in Bellefontaine. On top of pizzas, they have subs, sandwiches, salads, and lots of sides like breadsticks, garlic cheese bread, pickle chips, beer-battered onion rings, loaded fries, and more. Check out a specialty pizza this weekend. Ron's Pizza is ready to cook for you. Call 292-7775 or stop by and dine in on South Main Bellefontaine. See more and a menu online at Ron's Pizza's Facebook page.
Thank you.
Attention Fat Boys Pizza and Ice Cream customers, it's that time again. It's football time. Get your Fat Boys fix before the game or order while the game's going on. We're open till 10. We have hot pizzas, subs, and salads. 592 Fats.
Pizza the Hut, with classics like Meat Lovers, original stuffed crust, and their signature wings, pasta, and desserts. Order online or on the mobile app for carryout, curbside, or delivery. Pizza Hut. You can try, but you can't out Pizza the Hut. With
If you've never been to Saucy Sal's, you need to check it out. It's easy to find at the roundabout at State Route 47 and 235. They offer fresh deli meats, cheeses, and choice meats. They have it all. Saucy Sal's sauces and mustards are the best. That's why so many area restaurants use them. Pick up your favorites at Saucy Sal's. They offer fresh baked goods from Der Dutchman and lots of Walnut Creek items. There's even frozen food. Prices are reasonable and the service is great. Hurry to Saucy Sal's soon.
Our first song was featured in our pregame show. It's a song and dance dedicated to love. Let's see that drum line move to the Cupid Shuffle.
Did you get that? I'm just gonna put that on.
Always makes the marching boys feel good. So let's go ahead and play a song that makes everyone feel that way. It's Pharrell Williams' hit, Happy. Thank you. Our final song of the evening comes from our senior show, and it's pretty out of this world. So everyone, put your hands up and touch the sky while the band dances The Starships by Nicki Minaj.
When you're hungry for great Italian food, but you're also in a hurry, try Fazoli's of Bellefontaine. They offer delicious Italian meals like spaghetti and meatballs and chicken Alfredo fettuccine. They also offer great pizza and oven-baked subs. Be sure to download their rewards app. You'll get special offers, plus every dollar you spend, you get reward points to spend on future purchases. Fazoli's of Bellefontaine, open till 9.
Integrity Ford of Bellefontaine is more than just the home of the $29.95 oil change. It's the home of Ford in Logan County. Yes, at last, you loyal Ford owners have choices. Once again, you can find the Ford you want locally. And once again, there's a fully staffed service and parts department completely up to date with today's Ford technology. Finally, you can count on Integrity Ford for integrity. Because after all, the most important thing a dealer can give you is trust. Integrity Ford on 68 just south of Bellefontaine and at 9374.
James Farley and Seeley Funeral Home and Crematory in Highland Memorial Cemetery, your local funeral service provider, can handle all of you and your loved ones' funeral service wishes, wants, and needs inclusively at one convenient location. We may also travel to you or your loved one's local cemetery to honor your burial wishes there. Jennings Farley Seeley Funeral Home and Crematory in Highland Memorial Cemetery, conveniently located on US 68, just north of the Green Hills community.
We're back at Bolas Field in London, where it is halftime. A rousing halftime performance from the Bellefontaine and Granville marching bands, and a rousing first half performance by these football teams, putting on an offensive display in that first half. Bellefontaine leading here at the intermission by the count of 25-15 in this Region 11 regional semifinal. Dave Bezusko and Brandon Stockton back with you. And Brandon, very entertaining first half of play, very closely contested, and it is on the scoreboard. It has been on the field throughout.
Yeah, I mean, both teams came out firing on all cylinders, offense. And, you know, we made the comment, you know, is what defense is going to make some big plays, you know, down the stretch. And, you know, in the first half, Bellefontaine was able to make, you know, get the ball off a turnover, stop Granville, and, you know, right before the half, and you know, Granville themselves, you know, made a couple stops down here on fourth down, made a stop down here on fourth down. So I think it was just it's going to come down to what coaching staff makes the right adjustments and maybe possibly who has the ball last.
Bellefontaine had the ball first,
yeah,
and they came right down the field and scored off the opening kickoff. Six plays, 80 yards. Tavian St. Clair found Riley Neer from 48 yards out and over the top, made the score 7-0 Chieftains less than 3 minutes into the game. But in seven plays, Granville went 70 yards, and they capitalized on a touchdown pass. It was Beckett Long to the tight end, next, and Messner from 33 yards out, and that was on a little piece of chicanery as they had the pitch back to the quarterback on that play, and Messner was wide open down the near sideline. That made the score 7-7. In the next offensive possession, the Chiefs got a big kick return on the ensuing kickoff by Riley Neer. Set him up across midfield. Harper Scott toted in a 14-yard touchdown run to cap that drive. At the 3:34 mark of the first quarter, it was 14-7, but back came the Granville Blue Aces, and this time they had a long one, long to Culver, 59 yards down the near sideline as the defender fell down. Culver ran it all the way in, and then the botched extra point attempt for Granville that actually worked out for the Blue Aces. After a bad snap, it was picked up by the holder, who is the quarterback, Beckett Long, and after he almost got corralled in the backfield, he whipped around and found Culver again for the two-point conversion. That put Granville up momentarily 15-14, but the Chiefs would come right back and score. And less than 2 minutes later, they had the lead when Chris Fogan ran one in from 33 yards out. That made the score 21-15, Bellefontaine. And then the rest of that second quarter was scoreless. In the last 11 minutes, no one able to dent the scoreboard. Bellefontaine came away with two takeaways on Granville, but on both possessions, the Blue Aces stopping Bellefontaine on fourth down plays on the other side of the 50, and thus we are in a six-point situation with the Chiefs up 21-15 at the half. Brandon, Bellefontaine has 268 yards of total offense already, but Granville also has 225. The Chiefs have been able to split theirs up, 138 rushing to 130 passing, whereas Granville's been almost exclusively through the air. All but just a handful of their yards have actually been through the aerial assault. And so thus we have come to this point, the Chiefs with this lead. Tavian St. Clair, not as accurate as normal tonight, or some dropsies from the receivers. He is 9 of 17 passing for those 130 yards and the touchdown. Now, Riley Neer's been spectacular. 7 catches for 119 yards and a score. And Chris Fogan's already rushed for over 100 yards tonight at 14 carries and 104 and the score. Meantime, Beckett Long for Granville, 9 of 21 passing for 180 yards, 2 touchdowns, and an INT. What else do we think here before we hit some scores of other games?
Just, I think if you're Bellefontaine, you want to continue to have balance going forward. You know, Granville's defense was, you know, they couldn't stop Bellefontaine early in the first quarter and in the second quarter. So if you're Bellefontaine, you got to continue to have balance. And on defense, if you're Bellefontaine, you can't, you know, you got to watch out for the trick plays and stay contained on the outside. As I think, you know, Granville is going to try to, you know, their quarterback, you know, he's shown that he's able to use his legs a little bit. So I think you're going to have to contain him as well here in the second half.
The winner here will play the winner of the game between Bloom Carroll and Bishop Watterson, the Eagles of Watterson, the number one seed, trailing at halftime to Bloom Carroll 10-7. Bloom Carroll's the defending state runner-up in Division III. That would be in a regional final next week. The Springfield Shawnee Braves, the other CBC team remaining in postseason play, are into the third quarter in their game against the Wyoming Cowboys, and Wyoming has a 7-6 lead in that one. Also, the West Jefferson Rough Riders are in the postseason carrying the OHC flag, and the Rough Riders have a 28-24 lead over Fort Fry in their regional semifinal matchup. Those are your scores on the Quest Federal Credit Union out-of-town scoreboard. Here it is 21-15, Bellefontaine. Want to step aside and do one more break before we come on back for the third quarter? You're listening to Bellefontaine Chieftains football on 107.3 The Drive.
Are you looking for a place to tan or do your laundry? Buckeye Wash and Tan has you covered. Their goal is to provide you the highest level service and products in a clean and friendly environment at an affordable price. Their laundry facility is fast, reliable, and saves you time. Full service will take care of the laundry for you. There's always an attendant on duty. Ohio weather can be dreary at times. Getting a tan helps you feel good all year long, regardless of the weather. They provide clean and well-maintained beds to help you feel your best. Let Buckeye Wash and Tan brighten your clothes and your day.
Pizza Hut. You can try, but you can't out-pizza the Hut. With classics like Meat Lovers, original stuffed crust, and their signature wings, pasta, and desserts. Order online or on the mobile app for carryout, curbside, or delivery. Pizza Hut of Bellefontaine. No one out-pizzas the Hut.
Back at Bolas Field in London, Dave Bezusko, Brandon Stockton with you here. Evan Cook back at our studios at 107.3 The Drive. We also have Lou Vito and Gary Kauffman with us. Video streaming at nfhsnetwork.com tonight. And you'll see the replay for free tomorrow at peakofohiotv.com. And we have a Dairy Queen of Bellefontaine kickoff coming from Bellefontaine here to start the third quarter as Alex Crable will tee it up at the 40-yard line to our left. That huge Logan County contingent off of that far sideline. The stands absolutely packed, and fans, I'm not kidding, 6-7 people deep along the railing trying to get a glimpse of this football game. Here's the kickoff by Crable. It's a squib kick that goes all the way back to the deep return man back at the 15-yard line. And here comes Jack Yeager, and he got belted down at about the 27-yard line as the Chiefs get to him. He'll get peeled up off the turf.
I don't think he knows where he's at.
Here he comes to the near side. I think he'll be all right. Chieftains football. I'm sorry. The Blue Aces football at the 27-yard line to start half number two. They will come out in navy blue tops, white pants, silver helmets. Look a little like the Dallas Cowboys, Brandon. Brandon says, no, I think so. Silver helmets with that G that looks like the Green Bay or Georgia Bulldogs G on the sides of their helmets. Two receivers left, two receivers right. And on first down, the quarterback keeper up the middle and a terrific tackle by Hayden Manns, who came in and made the leg tackle on Beckett Long after a short gain of one.
Now, I think you're going to see Granville go down fighting with what they do best, and I think that's running the quarterback. And nice job there by Hayden Manns as he was able to squeeze down and make the tackle for a minimal gain.
Granville scored their first two offensive possessions, but they did not score on their third, fourth, or fifth possessions in that first half. They come out with the football moving from right to left on second down and nine. Long takes the shotgun snap, hands off Noah Music. He tries straight ahead running, but the Chiefs bottle that up after a short gain of three. And from the bottom of the pile comes Caden Folk. It'll bring up third down and about six. Noah Music only has 7 yards on two carries tonight. They've been almost all passing tonight.
Yeah, you can see, in the Bellefontaine faithful, standing on this third down and six. If you're Bellefontaine, you kind of want to watch out for the quick outs. And they love those middle of the field.
Chiefs almost came on a blitz, and Caden Folk almost jumped the line of scrimmage. Yeah, he got back. It's a play clock down to 7-6. Long all alone in the backfield. Four receivers wide right. Here they come, the Chiefs on a blitz. Jaden Temple running up his back. Pass far side. It's caught. Verasso's got it. He's got a first down on the far side. Numbers at the 37-yard line. And Beckett Long finds his receiver, but there's a whistle and a flag against Granville. And it's coming back. A Bellefontaine Police Department penalty against the Blue Aces. No first down conversion. It is holding against the Blue Aces.
Wow.
The Bellefontaine Police Department reminds you, do not text and drive. The Bellefontaine Police Department also says, do not hold against the Bellefontaine Chieftains. It's going to be third down and 16. The football all the way back at the 21-yard line. Actually, they need to get it out to the 37. Yeah, it's third and 16.
Yeah.
They're in the shotgun with two backers back there, too. They set up the screen over the middle. The pass is caught. The 25.
Nice.
He's out to the 30,
Caudill.
To the 32, and Carter Caudill playing right over the middle. Covered that up. The catch was made.
Fourth and five.
But, yeah, nowhere near the first down line to gain. Noah Music out of the backfield caught it and took it for a gain of about 11. But it's going to bring up fourth down, and Granville, for the fourth consecutive possession, will not be able to convert. They'll have to punt it for the first time tonight.
Well, you think they're going to punt it. They might try to fake this.
Now they're at their own 31-yard line. Bodie Shopes is the punter, and he does fake it. Look at this, Brandon. You called it. 30-yard line. He's sprinting toward
first
that
down.
Marker. He's taken down. He got it by a yard. He got it by a yard.
That was not their regular punt formation.
Brody Shopes.
That was not that regular punt formation.
And how about Coach Schroeder, who goes for the fake punt on fourth down, and Bodie Shopes sprints to that far side. He got about 8 yards.
Guts, that's what that was. I would say something else, but I'm on the radio.
I am thinking what you wanted to say too,
yes,
Brandon.
That was very gutsy.
Yeah, to put it mildly. From the 38-yard line, first and 10, Granville. And the quarterback gets away from trouble in the backfield, squirts ahead. He gets taken down all the way out of the 45-yard line, finally, by Jaden Temple. Somehow, Long made something out of nothing and got 7 yards.
Yeah, good coverage down the field by Bellefontaine. He looked several times.
They don't huddle. They quickly come to the line. Pass near side. Verasso, it's a screen. They set it up with a blocker. Verasso gets taken out of bounds at the midfield stripe by Kalen Organ. But another pickup of about 7. They really screened the Verasso a lot. He's got 8 catches for 60 yards.
Yeah, he seems like he's their go-to. I would say he's their go-to receiver.
Without question.
Whenever you need something, you know, he's your go-to guy.
Clock at 8:56 to play here in the third quarter. Chiefs lead it 21-15. Granville's opening drive out of the locker room. They got a fake punt for a first down. Now a quarterback keeper with the read option. He runs left side, got thrown down by Riley Neer at the 45-yard line. But, yeah, he got 5 yards more. Beckett Long has 31 yards on 5 carries. I'm sorry, on 10 carries. And it's going to bring up second down and 5 for the Blue Aces.
He does a nice job of setting up blocks and cutting off the block, and that's one thing. You know, you don't think that much is there, but once he cuts off that block and finds opening space, you know, he's able to get 1, 2, 3, 5 yards a pop.
Long back to throw again. He's getting flushed out of the pocket, rolls to the far side, almost got hit, and it's caught, but immediately tackled, smothered, in fact, by Harper Scott, the receiver.
He lost yardage on
that. That was going to be number 5, Maxton Messner. Yeah, he lost a couple. Back to the 48-yard line, sets up 3rd and 8. They did lose 3 yards on that play as Harper Scott was all over it. Chiefs trying to regroup after the fake punt. It's 3rd down and 8. Ball across midfield at the Chieftain 48-yard line. With the football on the right side hash, 3 receivers to the near side left, another to the far side right. Shotgun snap. Beckett Long rolls to his left. Will fire it left side. And it's incomplete. He underthrew his intended receiver, Verasso, across the line to gain at the 38-yard line. Jaden Temple, Chris Fogan were there in coverage. It brings up 4th down again. 4th down and 8. You know, they went for it before. Why wouldn't you do it again?
No, I think you punt this.
You think?
Yeah. I think you have to.
They went for the fake punt. They're lined up to go for it. That's what I'm saying. If you fake punted it at your own 30, you're going to go for it at midfield. Clock at 7:36 to play third quarter.
Play clock's down to 10.
Chiefs lead it 21-15. They line up to go for it. Two receivers to either side, and now he backs away like he's going to punt it, and the quarterback will kick it. No one's back for the Chiefs. It bounces at the 15, and it's going to die. It'll roll dead at the 14-yard line, so it's going to be a punt of about 34 yards with no return. And Bellefontaine will have the ball. 7:26 to play here in the third quarter with your score on the Quest Federal Credit Union scoreboard. Granville leading, trailing Bellefontaine. Bellefontaine with the lead, 21-15. Tonight's game brought to you by Buckeye Washington, your full-service laundromat and tanning salon. So the Chiefs will have it for the first time here in the second half, leading 21-15. Chiefs haven't scored since their third offensive possession of the night. Tavian St. Clair comes out there, 9 of 17 passing for 130 yards and a touchdown. The give goes to Chris Fogan, the handoff to the left side, and Fogan's bottled up. He was in traffic the whole time, ran it to about the 18-yard line. Fogan over 100 yards rushing, 108 yards on 15 carries. It's second down and 6.
Yeah, I think, you know, going back to the first half and, you know, Bellefontaine being so successful is, I think, the reason why they were so successful was the play, the yardage on first down they were getting. And we're going to see, you know, here what adjustments have been made by Granville.
Handoff up the middle, yep. Fogan. He's got some blockers. He's got a hole, and he's out over the 25 to the 27-yard line. And Chris Fogan with a terrific path that was led that time by Owen Larrison.
Mm-hmm.
And he's got it near the first down marker. It's, in fact, first and 10. So a good run that time for Fogan all the way out to the 27-yard line.
Yeah.
He got 9.
Yeah, I think you might see Bellefontaine do what they did last week against London in the second half, is come out and control the ball, control the line of scrimmage, and, you know, get out of here with a victory.
Hand off Fogan again. A yep. quick burst to the line. Then he got holed up at the 30-yard line. He'll got 3. The Chiefs content to run the ball here and run clock. We're down to 6:10 to play already. Here in the third quarter, Bellefontaine 21, Granville 15.
Hey, I'm okay with that. Continue to run this clock, man. I'm cold.
It's got nothing to do with being cold as much as it does keep Granville's offense off the field.
Yeah. And,
you know, the Chiefs have done a nice job. No turnovers last week, no turnovers this week, no turnovers since the playoffs have started, right? And here's St. Clair passing the football far side. Riley Neer's got it. Makes a turn upfield. Ducks out of bounds across the 40. It's a first down. Riley Neer out to the 42-yard line. That's a gain of 12. And you mix up those runs and passes, and a deadly mix for the Chieftains on offense.
Well, I think that had a lot to do with how far the DB was playing off. He's playing off of about 12 yards.
They've been doing that all night.
Yeah, it's when it's second and 5 and 6. If you're a DB, hey, if you beat you deep, that's fine, but you don't want to give up. He's playing way deep.
First and 10, give Fogan. Fogan follows blockers down the right sideline, and boy, a convoy of blockers. Owen Larrison, Jack Varner leading the way. Brody Boy all the way out there as well. Across midfield with Chris Fogan to the 46-yard line of the Blue Aces. Give the Chiefs 12 more yards.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I think, you know, like you're seeing a dose of what they did last week in the second half against London is, you know, controlling the line of scrimmage. Granville's in a three-man front, so if you're Bellefontaine, you like those odds. You got 5-0-3, you get those linemen moving, and I like the chances.
From the 46-yard line of Granville, ball between the hashes. St. Clair pitches at Fogan. Fogan left side. Sidesteps a defender in the backfield. Moves ahead across the 45 between the hashes to the 43-yard line. Chris Fogan, we're going to give him 3 more, and it's going to bring up 2nd down and 7. Fogan's been a workhorse, as he was a week ago.
Mm-hmm.
He's got 19 carries now tonight for 135 yards. What a difference. He did not play, of course, was hurt in the Granville game last year. This time, Hayden Manns, Riley Neer, and Zane Tevis all come wide to the near side in a triangle set. This is where they like to set up the screen. Let's see if it's a screen to Riley here on the near side right. This will be the handoff up the middle instead. Fogan straight ahead running, got leg tackled at the 39-yard line.
Third and 4?
Yep, he got 4 more on that one. I think it's 3rd and about 3.
Yep.
Clock continues to tick. 4:20 to play here in quarter 3. Bellefontaine leading 21-15. here in this regional semifinal, the Sweet 16. Granville fans rise to their feet, hoping their defense can come to life. The Chiefs are 3-for-5 on third downs tonight. Triangle receivers at the end of the line left. Here's the handoff, fake handoff to Harper Scott. Tavian keeps it, runs ahead, not getting the first down. He's tackled at the 37.5 yard line. He's about a yard and a half shy.
Yeah, I think you see Bo Fountain go for it here.
It's fourth down for the Chiefs. They're going to need about a yard and a half.
Mm-hmm. Oh, they're calling it fourth and two. I mean, fourth and a half, one and a half, fourth and two.
Chiefs are 0-for-2 on fourth downs tonight. What a big play this is for Bellefontaine, trying to maintain possession, leading by six. From the 37-yard line, Granville loads up the block. They almost came early on the snap count. Tavian resets it. Harper Scott's off his left hip in the backfield. Snap, give, Scott. Scott threw a hole, first down and more. Inside the 35, runs over a defender to the 31-yard line. The Chiefs get 7 yards on fourth down and move the sticks.
Yeah, nice cutback by the young man because the interior line started to cave in, but he able seen the hole opened up right off the tackle off the left side. He was able to squirm away and get 7 yards for a first big first down there for Bellefontaine.
The Chieftains with the lead, 21-15. The Chieftains with the ball and on the move at the Granville 31-yard line, moving from left to right. White tops, white pants, black bottoms with black numbers and red trim. Bellefontaine moving on this Bullis Field turf here in London. Harper Scott exits the backfield. Tavian fakes a throw to him. Now fires the ball deep downfield. Riley Neer streaking open. Makes the catch at the goal line. Touchdown. Bellefontaine does it again. Tavian St. Clair hits Riley Neer on a post pattern. They score it from 31 yards out. And the Chiefs are up 27-15. For Riley, it's his second touchdown catch of the night, his ninth overall catch for 162 yards. The Chiefs are up by 2 scores. Now a Fissile floor covering point after touchdown attempt. They are talking about going for two with the ball spotted right now at the 3-yard line, and they have their offensive set out there. Remember, Granville got a 2-point conversion back in the first half. So trying to make this a 14-point lead, they line up to go for two. St. Clair in the backfield with Fogan off his right hip, takes the snap, hands off Fogan. It's a reverse. Pitch to Neer. Neer coming back to the near side. Riley Neer will win the race to the goal line. He scored it. Riley Neer got hit at the goal line, but crossed it, and the Chiefs are up 29-15. What an exciting play on that 2-pointer. And the Chiefs take a 2-score lead with 2:38 to play in the third quarter. Your score on the Quest Federal Credit Union scoreboard. It's Bellefontaine 29 and Granville 15. We'll step aside. You're listening to Bellefontaine Chieftains football on 107.3 The Drive.
Looking to save money every month? Well, who isn't? With a Quest MasterCard, you can lock in a low fixed interest rate from 5.99 to 11.9% APR for qualified cardholders. You can even perform balance transfers from other high-interest cards and save real money every month. Apply online today. Membership and credit score eligibility required. Quest Federal Credit Union. Explore the possibilities. NCUA insured. Equal opportunity lender.
At Easton Water, we're fully committed to fulfilling our promises to our customers. As a locally owned, staffed, and operated company, our reputation is critical, and we mean what we say. We want to be your trusted source for everything water. If recent changes in the market have left you high and dry when it comes to drinking water, water softeners, salt, or anything else to do with the water in your home or business, we're here for you and would love to be your trusted water partner. Visit eastonwater.com or give us a call and we'll get you added to our route.
Back at Bullis Field in London, where the Bellefontaine Chieftains have gone up by 2 scores, they lead Granville now 29-15. Brandon, a terrific response for the Chieftains. They go 86 yards on their first possession of the third quarter after holding Granville out of the end zone on the opening drive, and now a 2-score lead.
Yeah, and they continue to, you know, have balance on offense and keeping the Granville defense on his heels a little bit. And, you know, I think 4 consecutive plays they ran, you know, the same play and got positive yardage on the same one. So, I mean, if you're Granville, if you're Bellefontaine, you like what you see from your offense. You know, good, a good balanced attack, and it's keeping this Granville defense at bay.
And now the Dairy Queen and Bellefontaine kickoff coming from the foot of Alex Crable. It will be sent end over end to that far side, and it's dropped by Culver at the 4-yard line. Picks it up and comes back out over the 10, near the 15, but not to the 15, as the Chiefs get down and cover them up good on kickoff coverage, and the Blue Aces will start deep in their own territory.
Yeah, it seems like, you know, they've come out, and the highlight of the Granville in the third quarter has been that fake punt, but other since that, they haven't done anything.
Tonight's game brought to you by Jack and Doe's, the home of the original sheet pizza. On the out-of-town scoreboard, brought to you by Quest Federal Credit Union, Bishop Watterson has taken the lead on Bloom Carroll. That is a 14-10 score in favor of the top seed, Bishop Watterson. The winner of that game plays the winner of this game in the regional championship next week. Bellefontaine with a 29-15 lead. Beckett Long will try to set up a screen over the middle and overshot his intended receiver, Dante Verasso, and they cannot connect. And so it'll be second down and 10.
I wonder why he didn't throw that to the wide receiver that was wide open on the bottom of the, you know, coming towards us. I hadn't.
Beckett Long is 17 of 26 passing for 195 yards tonight and two touchdowns. And on second down, fake handoff, pop pass over the middle, and it's juggled and caught by Culver. That if
that
he didn't catch
luck,
it would have been picked off.
Yes.
So somehow he was able to corral it, and he got a first down out of it as he juggled it all the way to the 28-yard line, a bullet pass over the middle for 15 yards. How about that, Jacob Culver? Football at the 28-yard line. Long out of the shotgun, takes the snap. Time in the pocket. Will heave it deep down the near sideline, looking for Verasso, and it's incomplete. And they're going to not throw a flag.
Wow, he pushed off on the Bellefontaine defender.
Yeah, the Bellefontaine defender ended up 20 yards downfield.
Yeah.
That was Harper Scott in coverage.
No, that was Kalen Oregon.
It'll be second down and 10. 2:06 to play here in the third quarter. Chiefs with a 29-15 lead. Brandon, can you believe how many people are here from Bellefontaine? Look at that far sideline.
Yeah, there's a lot. There's a
packed.
Lot of people.
The seats can't hold them over here in London's Bolas Field. Glad you're with us here at 107.3 The Drive, streaming at Peak of Ohio, and also on the NFHS Network. Second down and 10. Long. Pumps, throws deep and incomplete, but they'll catch a flag down here. Oregon
double
and
move.
Verasso again hooking up along the near sideline, and I think they'll catch Kalen Oregon for the pass interference call.
They called that one, but they didn't call the first one.
For Bellefontaine, Brandon, that is only the second marked off penalty of the night.
Yeah, they've played a flawless game. I mean, especially, you know, two quarters and 10 minutes into the game, they've actually played very disciplined football.
One more score on the out-of-town scoreboard brought to you by Quest Federal Credit Union. Shawnee has a 14-7 lead on Wyoming.
Wow.
That game into the fourth quarter.
Wyoming's a number one seed, aren't they?
I know they had their win streak snapped. I'd have to go look that one up, to be honest. I don't know if they're the one.
Gotcha.
Football up to the 43-yard line. Granville in blue tops, silver helmets, white pants, move from right to left, trailing 29-15. Pass far side and incomplete. He tried to go all the way to the sideline. And guess what? You got Kalen Oregon over there matching up defensively with a different receiver that time. And he was able to defend it well.
Yeah, you got Bellefontaine's corners jumping the routes. I mean, they don't respect Granville going deep. So they're jumping the routes. And if I'm Bellefontaine, if I'm the defensive coordinator from Bellefontaine, I'm telling the DBs, hey, you know, be easy. Keep everything in front of you because you don't want to get – you got a two-score lead. You don't want anything behind you to get them back in the football game.
1:57 to play third quarter. Bellefontaine 29, Granville 15. Chiefs showing a blitz. They do not come just with the front four. Pass near side. Caught.
Verasso
gets away from the defender. Zigzags around the defender again across the 30 inside the 25-yard line. That's exactly what you called for, Brandon, and Verasso burns him all the way down to about the 24-yard line of the Chieftains. A big gainer as they go for 34 yards.
That's a big one there because Yeah, I don't know. Maybe I've been out of the football game. I've been out of the coaching game too long, man. I don't.
Two receivers left, two receivers right. Shotgun snap, long back to throw, time in the pocket, fires it left sideline again, an incomplete overshot, a leaping Maxton Messner at the 19-yard line. Jaden Temple was in coverage alongside Riley Neer, second down and 10. Bellefontaine leading 29-15. Granville hasn't scored
since late in the first quarter.
Yep. The Chiefs have done a nice job bottling up this high-powered offense of the Granville Blue Aces. Two receivers to either side again, long back to throw, time in the pocket, flips one over the middle and incomplete. Was that pass batted at the line of scrimmage?
No, he actually hit the receiver right in the numbers and he just dropped it.
Well, he bobbled and dropped at the 19-yard line. There was a defender behind him. Again, Maxton Messner can't come up with it. Sets up third down and 10 here for the Blue Aces. Football spotted at the 25-yard line, third down and 10. Granville 4-for-8 on third down. And back to throw is long, rolling to his left. He'll flip it out left sideline, and the pass is caught. The Chiefs tried to go after the ball again defensively, lost as the ball was not picked off or knocked down. Receiver catches it as he rolls to the turf, and it's a first down. That is going to be Culver over there. Spotted at the 15-yard line, he got 10.
I'm okay with that, though. I can live with that because here's the thing. I mean, it's third down and long. You don't want to get beat. I mean, you don't want to get beat deep, but you also don't want to give up that first down. So, but nonetheless, that was a great pick. That was a great pass, great catch.
Granville into the Elevate Chiropractic red zone. Football at the 15-yard line, going to that north side end zone. Beckett Long takes the shotgun snap. It's a quarterback roll out to the near side. He keeps it through a hole at the 10-yard line, makes his cut at the numbers to the 5, down to the 4-yard line. Beckett Long on the quarterback draw. He gets 42 yards. And I'm sorry, he got 11 yards. Now he has 42 yards rushing on the game. He's down to the 4-yard line, Brandon, and the Granville Blue Aces are knocking on the door.
Yeah.
Clock under a minute to play third quarter. Bellefontaine has a 29-15 lead, but here come the Blue Aces about to score. Football at the 4-yard line. They bunch the formation. Long will take the shotgun snap. Quarterback keeper, and he gets buried back at the 6-yard line. The blocking never developed, and Chris Fogan made the tackle.
I think he's seen that he wasn't going to go anywhere, and I think he just nosedived right at the 5-yard line.
Clock under 30 seconds. They do not have to snap it here before the quarter, but they're down 2 scores. It might be in their best interest to do so.
Yeah, before the fourth quarter, and I don't think they're going to do that.
They line up. They spread the field. The backfield is empty. It's the quarterback and no one else. Man in motion. It's going to be a pass play over the top, and it's incomplete. Looking for Messner. He got his left hand on it and couldn't haul it in on a little tight end pop pass over the left side of the line, and it sets up third down and goal now for the Bellefontaine Chieftain defense. Chance to get off the field here without points if you can keep them out. There's 2 seconds left in the third quarter.
Well, I'm going to question Granville's play calling here. You got a wide receiver that's 6'5", sitting on the sideline, number 11, who's been in on blocking downs, you know, on running downs. Throw him the football.
Well, he's not even out there.
I know. I don't get it.
Ferrasso lines up at the end of the line to the left. It's going to be Beckett Long taking this whistle and what? The flag comes, and it's a delay of game or a false start? It's a false start. It's a false start. False start against the Granville Blue Aces. And a Bellefontaine Police Department penalty will push him back to the 9-yard line for this big third down play.
It's going to be hard, man. It's kind of hard for refs to miss.
All right. 2 seconds remain here in the third quarter. Chieftains looking for the goal line stand.
It's third down and 5. Or no.
Third and goal.
Third and goal from the 10.
Yep. Long will take the shotgun snap. He rolls to his left, looks end zone, throws it that way. It's fronted and almost picked off by the Chiefs. Riley Neer.
Good play.
Another play where they go after the football and Riley knocks it down. We will go to the quarter break with the score on the Quest Federal Credit Union scoreboard. Bellefontaine 29 and Granville 15. You're listening to Bellefontaine football on 107.3 The Drive.
Means no cooking. Check out what's hot at Ron's Pizza in Bellefontaine. On top of pizzas, they have subs, sandwiches, salads, and lots of sides like breadsticks, garlic cheese bread, pickle chips, beer-battered onion rings, loaded fries, and more. Check out a specialty pizza this weekend. Ron's Pizza is ready to cook for you. Call 292-7775 or stop by and dine in on South Main Bellefontaine. See more and a menu online at Ron's Pizza's Facebook page.
12 minutes on the scoreboard clock here in London's Bolas Field. Bellefontaine has a 29-15 lead over the Granville Blue Aces. Fourth quarter action brought to you by the Roof and Benchick Law Office in Kenton. Brandon, the two-score lead, but a huge fourth down and goal play coming up for Granville from the 9-yard line.
Yeah, if you're Granville, I mean, especially for Bellefontaine's defense, I mean, you have the opportunity of, you know, turning them away again, you know, in their two possessions that they've had, turning them away both times. So if you're Granville, I don't know if you have a – I don't know. You know, their best success have come off trick plays. I mean, if you're Bellefontaine, you know, just keep everything in front of you and don't let it – you know, keep your heels on the goal line. Don't let anything in front of you.
Buckle up, Chief fans. Here we go. Beckett Long about to take a shotgun snap as the Blue Aces now move – toward that south side end zone from left to right. And a whistle and what? We're going to have a
timeout.
Yeah. And who took it?
Bellefontaine.
Okay, the Chiefs take one as Coach Brown and company want to talk over this critical play. High school football is brought to you by Fazoli's of Bellefontaine. Great Italian food. The winner here will play either Bishop Watterson or Bloom Carroll in the regional final next week. And the Eagles, the top seed Eagles,
opened it up.
They do. They have scored 20 unanswered points on Bloom Carroll, and they lead the defending state runner-up 20-10. The Chieftains with the two-score lead here, a 21-15 lead at halftime. But then Tavian St. Clair hit Riley Neer over the top for the second time tonight. Long bomb, 31 yards for the touchdown, and the Riley Neer two-pointer near the end of the third quarter gave the Chiefs the two-score lead at 29-15, and now looking to protect it out of the huddle in timeout break here. Football is on the 10-yard line. It is fourth down and goal for Granville. Verasso goes wide to the far side left, to the near side right. They bring Jacob Culver. They're the two big receivers for quarterback Beckett Long. Out of the shotgun, he takes the snap. He's looking left the whole way. Sends it over the slant, and it's knocked away. The Chiefs knock it away.
I think he dropped it, but nevertheless, it fell to the turf.
They were looking for Verasso, but he didn't come up with it as he crossed the goal line.
Wow.
And the Bellefontaine Chieftains turn away Granville on a fourth down play. And Bellefontaine will get the football back, leading 29-15 with 11:56 to go. Now, Bellefontaine with a chance to
put this game on ice.
Yeah. Now they're 90 yards away, but the ball control that they showed the ability
to run the football,
to run on this field the last 2 weeks. Chris Fogan, 20 carries, 139 yards through three quarters. He is in the backfield. Hayden Mann's in motion. They send Riley Neer in motion, too. Now Riley takes that pitch play as he zigs and zags over the middle of the field. He's over the 15-yard line and out to about the 20 as Riley Neer scampers for 10 on that little pitch play that he gets when he goes in motion.
It's a favorite play.
And a 10-yard pickup for Riley, his 10th catch of the night for 172 yards. And the Chiefs have it out to the 20-yard line where it's first and 10, coming out of the south side end zone, moving right to left. White jerseys, white pants, black helmets with the Chiefs script logo on the sides of those black helmets. Tavian St. Clair takes the shotgun snap, gives Chris Fogan, and he gets tied up at the line of scrimmage and tackled at the 23-yard line. Just as he was getting his speed going, he got only three.
It just says, you know, like I said, the success for Bellefontaine has come tonight on first down, how they've been able to run the football on first down. You know, early on in the early on in the game, they were able to pick up 6, 7, 8, 9 yards a pop. So, and you know, that holds true here as they were, I mean, yes, anything positive on first down for Bellefontaine is a plus this late in the football game.
Second down and 7. Granville loads up the block box with defenders. Give to Chris Fogan. Fogan tries the right side, and Fogan ahead to the 27, maybe the 28-yard line.
Uh-oh, we got a penalty flag.
And there's a late flag that comes in on this one. What's that all about? It's been a pretty clean game from the penalty perspective tonight, but this one's going to go against the Chiefs. They're marching backward.
You're going to get a personal foul, or what are you going
to
get?
I think you might. It was a late flag.
It was very
late.
We
haven't seen the indication. It's a Bellefontaine Police Department penalty. The BPD reminds you, do not text and drive.
Dead ball. Personal foul, right?
Yep.
Wow.
That's too bad.
Yeah, because
it was going to be third
and short. They've been so successful on first down to put themselves in position to, you know, even if they didn't pick up a lot of yards on second down, it would still be third and manageable. Now you got second and 14.
It's third down and 14.
Oh, yes.
The play counted post play foul.
Yes, third and 14 now.
Yeah, that was really, really not good.
Yeah.
Because the Chiefs now trying to close the game out, face third down
and
16 from the 14-yard line.
Yeah, 16, wow.
They sent three receivers to the near side left in a trips formation. Oh. C.J. Wilson, far side right. It's a draw play handoff. Chris Fogan tries the right side, and Fogan got upended at the 21-yard line after a gain of 7. And Bellefontaine will have to punt it away. Brandon, this could be our first punt of the night.
Yeah.
The Chiefs have not kicked it all night long, but C.J. Wilson will go back to take the snap.
Then you got another Granville player down on the side.
Yeah, an injury timeout for a Blue Ace. He's coming up, and here he comes to the near side. Looks like Drew Vaholic. High school football brought to you by Iron City Sports Bar on South Main in Bellefontaine. For Logan County's best burgers and wings, it's Iron City Sports Bar. And we say hello and thank all our friends over there, Matt Brown and company, for streaming the game tonight at Iron City Sports
Bar. There's a lot of places stream football. TP Lanes.
They've got it tonight. Yeah. 10-21 to play in the ball game. Bellefontaine leading 29-15.
Ron's
C.J.
Pizza
Wilson.
Too, sorry.
Ron's Pizza. Sure, that's the home of Chalk Talk on Wednesday nights. C.J. Wilson averages 38 yards a punt. He stands inside his own 5-yard line. And it's going to be, for the Blue Aces, Jacob Culver back deep. Here's a good snap back to CJ. He'll send a line drive kick nice Culver's point. Way. Oh. It's going to bounce and take a Chiefs roll. Oh, my goodness, on this field turf. It rolls and rolls and rolls. Inside the 30, inside the 25, all the way down at the 22-yard line. Now, how about math on the radio, Brandon? Let's see. That's a 58-yard punt with no return. How do you like that? As C.J. Wilson flips the field with a terrific punt. My goodness, that's a big special teams play for Bellefontaine.
Yeah, because you're looking at, if you're Granville, you're looking at good field position if you catch the football.
But it was a line drive kick. It was going to be tough to catch.
Now, yeah, you're taught. He just sat there and watched it go over his head. And that's a 10, 15, 20, 25-yard difference.
Yeah, yeah. 58-yard, no return.
See why you catch the football?
I do.
Yeah. I'd be livid.
Beckett Long is 20 of 36 passing, 254 yards, 2 touchdowns, and 1 INT. The junior will try to lead back the Blue Aces from a 2-touchdown deficit. On first down, it's a quarterback keeper. He sweeps the near side. Chiefs string it out. Kalen Organ and Harper Scott are there to combine on the tackle outside the numbers at the 28-yard line. Kalen's slow to get up. He got about 5, and it'll be 6. Second down.
Yep.
We'll give him
4.
6.
Yep, second and 4.
Blue Aces in blue tops, white pants, silver helmets. They move from left to right here on the field turf at Bolas Field. Clock rolling, 9:35 and counting in the ballgame. Chiefs up by 2 scores. Rolling left, the quarterback long throws it. Ferrasso catches. Ducks out of bounds at the 39. Give him the 40-yard line. Give him 12 more yards and a first down.
Yeah, I think Bellefontaine's kind of more in a two deep, trying to keep everything in front of them. Who's the DB on that side? Oh, it's Riley and Chris. So, uh-oh.
And now we have a whistle and what? Officials talking about something for a minute. For Dante Verasso, he's got 10 catches now, 106 yards for Granville. Clock at 9:23 to play in the ball game. Chiefs are nursing a 29-15 lead here in the fourth quarter of this Sweet 16 matchup. Bellefontaine's never won three postseason games in one season. They've got the chance to do that tonight.
Yep.
They've been as far as the regional finals twice in school history. They've got a chance to advance to that point tonight. They lead by two scores in the fourth quarter. Granville football out of the shotgun. Snap, Beckett long. Time to throw. All night to throw. Fires over the middle. It's knocked down by Carter Caudill. With the left hand, he batted it down as he was trying to throw into the middle of a zone, the quarterback, and no chance.
That was great defense there by Carter. Is he talk about depth. I mean, that play was – he swatted that down at the 45 on their side of the field. And he's playing 5 yards off the ball, so he had to drop 10 yards for depth to get to play his zone.
Second down and 10. Chiefs show blitz. They do not come. Rolling to his right, Beckett long. Pass near side, and it's knocked away. Chris Fogan was there on coverage with Jacob Culver on the near side, near midfield. It'll bring up third down and 10 for the Granville Blue Aces. Clock at 9:16 and counting, and Granville's really struggled on third down here as this game has gone along. They're 5 for 10.
Yeah, they started off good, though.
They did.
I think they were 2 for 2 or 3 for 3, something like that.
On the first drive.
Yeah, I think here recently.
Here's Long taking the shotgun snap. Looks right, now throws left. Verasso's got it with blockers in front of him. He slices across the midfield stripe, the 40, the 30, across the far sideline to the 20, and knocked out of bounds in the red zone at the 14-yard line. Dante Verasso got loose, and he takes a big play all the way deep into Chieftains territory. A 46-yarder to Verasso. And now the Blue Aces have it in the Elevate Chiropractic red zone.
Now, how big was that goal line stand?
And now this is going to be long on the quarterback keeper. And he's getting pinballed around on the right side. He'll get to the 11-yard line and push back. Jaden Temple is there. Harper Scott was there to help make the stop after a gain of 3.
Yeah, forward progress.
Chiefs lead it 29-15. You're not kidding about the last time down here on that stop.
Yeah.
The Chiefs are trying to make another red zone stop. And you're glad you've got the two-score lead for some insurance right now.
Yes, you are.
8:30 and a rolling fourth quarter clock. Bellefontaine 29, Granville 15. Blue Aces football, Beckett long out of the shotgun. Noah Music next to him in the backfield, snap. Throw, far side, end zone, throws it up for grabs, and it's called in a touchdown. Touchdown, Granville, against Chris Fogan defensively. I can't see who caught it up in the corner. He just threw it up for grabs. Was that Verasso? I think so, it was.
Yep.
Dante Verasso, who's been a huge target for his quarterback tonight. And they get an 11-yard touchdown connection on that play.
They're going to go for 2 on this?
And it is now 29-21. And they are indeed lining up to go for 2. Look at this.
What in the world?
Granville down by 8, lining up to go for 2. Verasso to that far side. Look for him. There's the pitch to him. Verasso wants to throw it back to the quarterback. He's not open. Verasso rolling to his right. He's in trouble. He zigs to the end zone. Does he get to the goal line?
No, he
He's
didn't
turned
get
away. The Chiefs didn't. He didn't get there.
Nope.
How did Verasso not score? The Chiefs bottled him up at the 1 yard line. It looked like if he could have lunged, he would have made it. He didn't do it. And the Chiefs do not allow that 2-pointer to score that time. And so with 8:18 to play in the ball game, your score in the Quest Federal Credit Union scoreboard, it is Bellefontaine 29, Granville 21, and we will step aside. You're listening to Bellefontaine Chieftains football on 107.3 The Drive.
Hi, everybody. This is Dr. Jacob from Elevate Chiropractic, Bellefontaine's newest chiropractic clinic. Aren't you tired of being in pain and not living life to your fullest? Chiropractic care not only relieves pain, but more importantly, it helps your body handle stress better in the long term. We tailor every adjustment specific to you with the help of our in-house digital x-ray suite, along with corrective stretches and exercises. It's time to take back control of your own health today. Visit ElevateChiroCare.com or call 937-210-5525 to schedule now.
Attention, Fat Boys Pizza and Ice Cream customers. It's that time again. It's football time. Get your Fat Boys fix before the game or order while the game's going on. We're open till 10. We have hot pizzas, subs, and salads. 592-FATS.
We're back at Bullets Field in London. 8:18 to play in the ball game. On the Quest Federal Credit Union scoreboard, it is Bellefontaine 29, Granville 21. The Blue Aces will kick off. It's a Dairy Queen and Bellefontaine kickoff. Would they dare try another pooch kick or onside kick of some kind? Bodie Shopes is about 15 yards behind the football. Now he is run up, and he does kick it deep. It's onto the far sideline and will roll all the way to the end zone just inside the pylon for a touchback. The Chiefs had 10 players up near the line and only one guy, Jaden Temple, back.
With 8 minutes left to go, they were so concerned. With
they were anticipating.
Kick. Yeah.
All right, Brandon.
Yep.
The lead has shrunk, and the Chiefs on offense now.
You don't change anything. You just continue to run the football.
Okay.
Granville, well.
A little pressure on the Chiefs right now.
No, well, here's the thing.
It's a one-possession game. Go ahead.
Yeah, I mean, one-possession game, but, I mean, you got Granville has to score and get the two-point conversion. So, for Bellefontaine, you know, you still they're still at your mercy. You can still do whatever you want to do. There's still 8 minutes left to go in the football game. You don't need to change anything.
Chiefs have it from their own 20-yard line, moving right to left. St. Clair wants to throw on first down, looking far side. It's dropped. C.J. Wilson with another drop. He was right there. He had it at the 25-yard line, had two hands on the ball. It just fell out of his hands.
Mm-hmm.
Tonight's game brought to you by Saucy Sal's. Let's get saucy. Maybe C.J. had a little Saucy Sal's on his fingertips and couldn't haul that one in. Second down and 10.
It's all a mental thing for C.J. now. You know, he's thinking too much.
He's wide to the near side left. Three receivers, triangle formation, far side, right hand off Fogan. Fogan follows all those blockers on the right side, triangle or diagonal running out across the 25 to the 26-yard line. He got six.
Going to be third and four now for Bellefontaine. Like I said, you don't need to change anything that you do. You can still run the football. You can still throw the football. You're still 7 minutes and 50 seconds left to go in the football game. You don't need to go into panic mode yet for Bellefontaine.
Yeah, it's a big third down, though.
It is. It's a very
– you don't convert it and give it right back after three and out, after Granville just scored. The Blue Aces fans rise to their feet, ringing cowbells, making all kinds of noise, stomping on the bleachers. It's third and four. Tavian to throw, near side, pass caught. Riley near behind the line, darts away from the defender. He breaks the tackle at the 40, the 45, the 50. Stutter step move and out of bounds at the 43-yard line of Granville. Riley near with more yards after the catch. Is he just magical after he catches the football or what?
I don't understand why you're not bumping and running, Riley. Especially on those type of plays, you know where the football's going. You bump and run him, knock him off his course, and make someone else beat you. And teams have an under – I don't understand it.
Riley Neer with a 30-yard play on that one. Takes the ball across midfield. Riley Neer has 11 catches for 202 yards and two touchdowns.
Yeah.
Chieftains lead it 29-21. 7 minutes and a rolling fourth quarter clock on first and 10. Give Chris Fogan right side. He's got the 40. He's got the 35 and taken down there. Chris Fogan with the good yards and a big hole off that right side of the line. They continue to blow defenders off the ball. You've got guys like Charlie Bible, and you've got Owen Larrison over there leading the charge, a 9-yard pickup.
Well,
25 carries, 168 yards for Chris Fogan. Some prolific numbers for the Bellefontaine superstars. Second down and one from the 35-yard line of the Blue Aces. Chiefs moving across midfield. They've got it. Granville loads the box, give Fogan, and he slipped as he tried to make a cut. behind the line of scrimmage, and he goes down behind the line at the 36-yard line for a loss of one on the play. And it's going to bring up
third and two,
6 minutes and counting here in the ball game. Chiefs protecting a 29-21 lead on Granville. Zane Tevis comes wide to the near side left. So does Riley Near. C.J. Wilson to the far side right. The rest of the team breaks the huddle.
See, like right now, number five, you have to be in Riley's face.
He's not.
Nope.
And the pass, so it won't be a pass. Give Harper Scott. Harper Scott hit the line.
He fumbled the football.
He fumbles the ball, and the ball is loose. Who's got it?
Granville's got it. Wow.
The first turnover of the postseason coming out with the football is Drew Vaholic. It comes at the worst possible time. Gives the football back to Granville. It'll be at the 34-yard line of the Blue Aces, and with 5:26 to go, they'll have a chance to march downfield and tie the game. Well, the defense going to have to come up big here for
yes,
the Chiefs. Bellefontaine leading it 29-21. Football at the 34-yard line. Their own 34, Granville, blue tops, white pants, silver helmets. They move left to right. On first down, Beckett Long rolls to his left. Sets up to throw. Comes firing back deep near the near sideline and overthrows the receiver. And guess who had a ball come off his hands again? Was C.J. Wilson.
Yeah, he tried to go up with one hand and grab it.
Defensively, C.J. had a chance.
Yep.
Couldn't come up with it. It'll be second down and 10, 5:20 to go.
I'm telling you
in
what,
the contest.
He's throwing in double coverage. He just lets it air.
He's just chucking it now.
Yeah, he just throws it up.
He's made 42 pass attempts tonight. He's completed 28 of them for 323 yards, three TDs and an INT. And this time, this is going to be the quarterback straight ahead running on the keeper to the 38-yard line. Beckett Long running, got four on that quarterback keeper. He's got 53 yards running as well. And it's going to be a big third down play here for the Blue Aces.
I'm here to tell you, I think, Bellefontaine's done a really nice job of, containing the quarterback run here tonight. He's their main guy of running the football. And they've done a nice job of squeezing and keeping everything right there in front of him and not letting him squirt out.
He's only had one play of 10 yards or more.
Yeah.
Chiefs show blitz. They back out of it on third down and six. Pass near side. It's intercepted. Kalen Oregon steps in front of the receiver and picked it off. Kalen Oregon with the INT on the near sideline. They've been jumping routes all night long, and that time it came up big for the Chiefs. They get the INT.
He doesn't even look. He just gets the ball and throws it.
It's his second INT. And for Kalen Oregon, he turns the ball back over for the Chiefs defense, which comes up big after the Harper Scott fumble, bails him out. And with 4:36 to play in the ball game, Chiefs have it with a 29-21 lead. How do you like that?
Wow.
And a huge play for the Bellefontaine
sure
defense.
Was.
And now a chance for the Chiefs to salt this away. First and 10 from the 41-yard line. Pitch it, Chris Fogan. Fogan tries the right side. Makes his cut at the hashes. He's inside the 35 and down to the 33-yard line. Chris Fogan got eight more yards. Chris Fogan is closing in on 200 yards rushing.
Yes.
And Riley Near has over 200 yards receiving already. What a night for the Bellefontaine offense, which has a 29-21 lead here on Granville in the Sweet 16. Brandon, so many people in this stadium, especially on that far sideline, standing and watching this one. The Chiefs, as the clock ticks under 4 minutes to go, are that close to the regional finals. Two receivers right, another to the left. Turn, give, Fogan. Fogan in traffic, carries the pile with him. Inside the 30, no, he's to the 31. He's down to the 31 and very near the line of the game.
They
move the sticks.
Yep, they gave it to him.
He got about 2 yards on the carry, and that's all he needed. And now Granville's got to start thinking about timeouts. They've got three left. Clock running at 3:40 and counting. And with a 40-second play clock, you can really run this down. Bellefontaine with the lead in the ball at the Granville 31-yard line. Wilson wide right. Fogan in the backfield. Near and Tevis wide to the near side left. Near in the slot, and he's motioning back toward the formation. Now he sets up. Give Fogan. Fogan, stutter step move through a hole. Goes right side and ahead to the 26. A gain of five more. And they'll be content to just run Fogan until they can stop him.
Yeah, well, they haven't stopped him all night.
No, they haven't.
I don't think here with 3 minutes left to go on the clock, you're going to notice anything different.
And they'll be content to let clock tick. We're under 3 minutes to go.
23 seconds on the play clock. You don't break the huddle until they're about 15. You don't snap the ball until there's about 2 or 3 seconds left on that play clock.
They bunch a set of receivers to the near side, and now Granville jumps the snap count. They knock the center down. Brody Boy does a nesty plunge backwards after he got hit to make sure the officials saw it, and they all did. Mm-hmm. A Bellefontaine Police Department penalty, the offsides encroachment. And that's going to bring the football to the 21-yard line and a first down by way of penalty for the Chiefs. Boy, oh boy, oh boy, the Bellefontaine fans making all kinds of noise on that far side. They can taste it now. Clock at 2:37 to play in the ball game. Bellefontaine 29, Granville 21. Chiefs. We'll let that clock run, but the play clock, but the scoreboard clock should be running. It's not, and now they're going to have to reset things. 2:37 to go in the contest. Now they wind the game clock. They had reset the play clock so that they could get the full 40-second complement. Granville needs to consider a timeout. They're not going to take it here. First and 10, Chiefs at the 21-yard line. Tonight's game brought to you by Patriots Attic. Lock it, load it, love it with Patriots Attic in Huntsville, your Logan County Firearms headquarters. Play clock down to 15. By the time they snap it, it'll be under 2 minutes, Brandon. Fogan off the right hip of Tavian St. Clair. Two receivers wide left, another far side right. Here's the stuff of the box. Fogan runs through a hole left side. He's into the clear, 15-yard line. He breaks a tackle at the 10, reverses his field to the 6-yard line. Chris Fogan with a run of 15 yards. It's first and goal, Bellefontaine. And the Chiefs are almost ready to salt this away. Granville takes a timeout.
Yeah.
We're going to take a timeout, too. Timeout on the field, 1:51 to go. Chiefs up 8. You're listening to Bellefontaine Football on 107.3 The Drive.
Jennings Farley and Seeley Funeral Home and Crematory in Highland Memorial Cemetery, your local funeral service provider, can handle all of you and your loved ones' funeral service wishes, wants, and needs inclusively at one convenient location. We may also travel to you or your loved one's local cemetery to honor your burial wishes there. Jennings Farley Seeley Funeral Home and Crematory in Highland Memorial Cemetery, conveniently located on US 68 just north of the Green Hills community.
Attention Fat Boys Pizza and Ice Cream customers, it's that time again, it's football time. Get your Fat Boys fix before the game or order while the game's going on. We're open till 10. We have hot pizzas, subs, and salads. 592 Fats.
Back at Bolus Field, 1:51 to go. Chiefs football out of the timeout. First and goal at the Granville 6-yard line. Chiefs winning 29-21 and a chance to salt this away right here. Tavian St. Clair out of the shotgun takes the snap. Give it Fogan. Fogan threw a hole. He's at the 5. He's to the 3. He's to the 2. Then we'll spot it. Well, let's see. They'll spot it at about the 3. Chris Fogan got 3 yards on the carry, and Granville takes another timeout. That run unofficially puts Chris Fogan to 201 yards rushing on the night. And Brandon, you know, one of the things that I think is incredible about the effort here tonight for the Chiefs is that, like last week, the stars came to play, but this has been a true team effort. It feels like we've called about every player on the roster at some point during the broadcast.
Yep. You know, with Fogan rushing over 200 yards and Riley Near, the game he's had, and, you know, Tavian's being Tavian, and you know, it's just it's hard for a defense to try to slow down this Bellefontaine attack, and you got to be, you know, I say that you got to out physical them. You know what I mean? On the outside, because the receivers and their skill position players are so good that that's the only way to offset this talent that they have and the speed that they have.
You know, one of the things you think about too with Bellefontaine that's been clicking on all cylinders for about 7 weeks now. Chiefs are a minute and a half away from their seventh consecutive win. Mm-hmm. Here's a handoff up the middle. Harper Scott slicing his way to the end zone. He fumbles the ball. The ball is loose.
Granville got it again.
Oh, my goodness. Oh, my goodness. Coming up with the ball for the Granville Blue Aces is Gavin Vredenburg. And for the second consecutive possession, you have Harper Scott fumbling when he refreshes Chris Fogan, and the touchback, as it's recovered by Granville in the end zone, will give the Blue Aces the ball with 1:40 to go.
But they don't have any timeouts left.
They have one timeout, and they have the ball. The fact that they have a chance at all is incredible, as Harper Scott coughs it up for the second time here in the fourth quarter. And now the Chieftains defense has to come up big one more time.
Yep.
They need a touchdown and a two-pointer. The Blue Aces are 80 yards away. They spread the field, two wide to either side. One back behind the quarterback, Beckett Long, who wants to throw on first down. He's flushed from the pocket, rolls to the right side, looks downfield, he'll tuck it to run, eludes a defender, turns upfield. He didn't go out of bounds, and he stays in bounds all the way up the sideline to the 32-yard line.
And you know what? And it's real early to say this, but going for two, when
last time?
I don't get it. I don't get it. But well, it's you're still 70-some yards away, 60-some yards away. So if you're Bellefontaine, again, Granville has one timeout left. You just have to keep everything in front of you.
Beckett Long to the 32-yard line. It is first down and 10. Clock stopped at 1:31 to go.
Yeah, but the play clock's down in 10.
Bellefontaine 29, Granville 21. Blue Aces football moving from left to right. Snap to Long. Fakes a pass short, throws it downfield and incomplete. He was looking for Jaeger, and the ball incomplete near midfield. And so it'll bring up second down and 10, 1:27 to go. In the contest, the Chiefs were at the 3-yard line. Had they scored that touchdown, they'd have won the game. Instead, a fumble into the end zone, recovered by Granville, gives the Blue Aces one final shot at this. This high-powered offense of Granville, they score it at over 35 points a game. They have 21 tonight. They need eight more. Chiefs have an eight-point lead. Long to throw. Back in the pocket. Time. Now he's going to scramble. He cannot get away as the tackle's made by Jaden Temple. Now Beckett fell forward across to the 35-yard line. He did not get out of bounds. Did he say he got out of bounds?
Yeah, he got out of bounds.
He got out of bounds at the 35-yard line and stopped the clock. And so the clock stops at 1:19 to play. That's a break for Granville, but it is third down. Third down, they need about seven from the 35-yard line. Football on the right side hash. Three receivers to the far side left. Chiefs showing a blitz, and they only come with three. Long back to throw. Hayden Mans breaks loose. Chases Long to the right side. Long to the sideline. Wrestled out of bounds there by Parker Knox. He got taken down out of bounds, and the Granville fans want a flag. They're not going to get it. That's a break for Bellefontaine, quite frankly, as Parker Knox spun the quarterback out of bounds once they're down to the turf once he was out of bounds.
But sets up a fourth down.
It is. Fourth down and seven. They have to get to the 42-yard line. Fourth and six from the 36-yard line. This play is the ball game. Chiefs have a chance here to get off the field defensively. The Chieftain defenders waving their arms, imploring the fans, who rise as one. Back to throw, Beckett Long, rolling right, throwing deep down the near sideline. He's got a receiver, Culver, and he's knocked away! Knocked away, Brody Boy and Riley Near were back there. They knocked it away. They had double coverage on the deep man, Jacob Culver. The pass falls incomplete. The Chiefs are going to get out of here with the win.
Yes, they are. And they, all those plays went to the short side of the field. Nothing went to the wide side of the field.
Bellefontaine able to hold up defensively, Brandon, after the back-to-back turnovers gave the ball back to Granville with chances to tie the game. And Bellefontaine's going to get out of here with the win.
Yeah,
the Chieftains are going to go to the regional finals.
Yes.
The Chieftains are going to win their third postseason game for the first time in school history. And it's victory formation for Bellefontaine. The snap for Tavian St. Clair. He genuflexed. He'll have to do it one more time. Well, 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 well.
Crazy.
There are fans waving Bellefontaine flags on that far side.
A lot of people are leaving, too. I'm not.
Well, I'll tell you what. You got to make your plans for where we're going to be next week. Bellefontaine will be playing Bishop Watterson in a regional championship game. Watterson's beat Bloom Carroll tonight 20-10. The Chiefs are going to get their shot at the top-seeded Eagles.
How about this? How
one
about
more
you,
snap.
You beat the
and there it is.
You beat the 3 seed, you beat the 2 seed, and now you got a shot at the 1 seed in the region.
Bellefontaine. The Chiefs have won 7 in a row. They are 11-2, and as the teams line up to congratulate one another, you had a hard-fought game tonight that comes down to the wire, and the Bellefontaine Chieftains win it by the count of 29-21 over Granville. What a ball game.
Good football game.
Absolutely. Let's step aside. We'll take a timeout and come on back and wrap this one up. The Chiefs are to the regional finals. You're listening to Bellefontaine Football on 107.3 The Drive.
Here's an important reminder from Jacobs Auto Repair. While school's out for the holidays and the kids are home from college, it's a great time to make sure their cars are ready for the upcoming winter weather. Simple things like having the battery and tires checked, making sure the heater is warming, and the defroster is working properly. A good checkup for their cars can save the kids and you stress. The last thing you want is to have your child stranded in bad weather. Give Jacobs Auto Repair a call today and get on the schedule. 592-2233.
Hi, it's Liz at Bellefontaine's Comfort Inn, reminding you we offer your out-of-town guests a comfortable alternative. Available amenities include in-room microwave and fridge, complimentary breakfast, outdoor pool, and on-site lounge. And king rooms come with hot tubs. It really does beat crowding into your house, and we're pet-friendly too. Reservations are easy at choicehotels.com or call 937-599-5555. That's Bellefontaine's Comfort Inn.
Integrity Ford of Bellefontaine is more than just the home of the $29.95 oil change. It's the home of Ford in Logan County. Yes, at last, you loyal Ford owners have choices. Once again, you can find the Ford you want locally. And once again, there's a fully staffed service and parts department completely up to date with today's Ford technology. Finally, you can count on Integrity Ford for integrity. Because after all, the most important thing a dealer can give you is trust. Integrity Ford on 68 just south of Bellefontaine and at 937-Ford.com.
Pizza Hut. You can try, but you can't out-pizza the Hut. With classics like Meat Lovers, original stuffed crust, and their signature wings, pasta, and desserts. Order online or on the mobile app for carryout, curbside, or delivery. Pizza Hut of Bellefontaine. No one out-pizzas the Hut.
Hi, it's Warren Rupp. To see what a roof by Warren might look like on your home, please visit our website, roofsbywarren.com. And remember, we have over 30 years' experience in dealing with insurance.
When the time has come and your roof needs done, the name you can call is Warren. When it finally stops pouring, it's time to call Warren. RoofsByWarren.com.
Roofs by Warren. See us at RoofsByWarren.com.
Is it over? Okay, yeah. It's, no, it's not over, but it's
We're back at Bolus Field in London, where the Bellefontaine Chieftains are victorious tonight. They defeat the Granville Blue Aces by the count of 29-21. The Chiefs are still alive, Brandon. They survived the Sweet 16, and this magical run continues to the regional finals. They're to the Elite Eight. They've made school history by winning the third postseason game in one season, and they advance to the regional finals for the first time. Well, I have to check the numbers there. Third time in school history.
Yeah.
Third time in school history.
Yes, third time in school history. And, you know, they're going to be facing a familiar foe that, you know, we always run up against when we get deep in the playoffs like this is, you know, Bishop Watterson. You know, back in the day, it was either run up against Bishop Watterson or Columbus DeSales. And
here we go again.
Not a lot's changed since then. But credit Bellefontaine as they were able to, you know, keep their composure and, as you know, fumbling the ball going into the end zone and, you know, not hanging their heads and stopping Granville, you know, on fourth down. And just, you know, just this team has a lot of grit. And that's basically, you know, that's half the battle. And, you know, now they're going to face a taller task in Bishop Watterson. And it's going to be something different that they haven't seen yet before this season.
Let's talk about tonight's game.
Yep.
You know, you talk about the Chiefs coming out strong. Both teams came out firing on offense. The first five possessions of the football game were scores. Chiefs scored the first time they had the ball, three times they had the ball, in fact. Tavian St. Clair to Riley Neer, a Harper Scott touchdown, a Chris Fogan touchdown. And then we didn't have any scores then for seemingly forever, as this became a defensive struggle for a long time. Then both teams scored back-to-back possessions there in the middle, end of the third, first start of the fourth quarter.
Mm-hmm.
The turnovers played a big factor in the second half. Three turnovers for Granville tonight really slowed them down. Mm-hmm. I mean, Bellefontaine didn't score any points off of them, but in fact, no points scored off any of the five turnovers in the football game tonight. But it was really a factor. Those turnovers slowed Granville down several times, and the Chiefs were able to really pounce on some of those routes and got some big INTs tonight.
Yeah, you had, like you said, you had the two interceptions by Granville's quarterback, one early in the fourth quarter as he, you know, on fourth down, and then you had the Bellefontaine stopping them, you know, fourth and down and goal at the 10-yard line, and you had, you know, Bellefontaine, putting the ball on the turf twice, once going into the end zone to put this game on ice. So if you're Bellefontaine, you just got to continue, you know, play with a lot of grit tonight. And, you know, they're going to need that fight for next week.
We'll take one more timeout. When we come back, we'll do the statistical analysis and more. Bellefontaine, a winner tonight on the road in London as they advance through the Sweet 16, defeating Granville 29-21, on to play Watterson next week in the regional final. You're listening to Bellefontaine Chieftains football on 107.3 The Drive.
Looking for a way to make your gun even more awesome? Come down to Patriot's Attic and get yourself a silencer. We take care of all the paperwork and fingerprints in-house, so the most stressful part for you is deciding which can to buy. The best part? When you buy silencer at Patriot's Attic, you're free to take it out of jail and use it on our range whenever you want while you're waiting for that form to be approved. So make that wait time worth it and come see us on County Road 130 between Huntsville and Bellefontaine.
Looking to save money every month? Well, who isn't? With a Quest MasterCard, you can lock in a low fixed interest rate from 5.99 to 11.9% APR for qualified cardholders. You can even perform balance transfers from other high-interest cards and save real money every month. Apply online today. Membership and credit score eligibility required. Quest Federal Credit Union. Explore the possibilities. NCUA insured. Equal opportunity lender.
Come to the pizza shop where all the locals know where to go. Jack and Doe's, a family tradition for over 50 years. Started by the Valentine family in the late 60s, it's now operated by the third generation. They were taught how to make delicious, quality pizza, subs, chicken, and more. Jack and Doe's, home of the original large sheet pizza. Visit their Facebook page or one of their three locations for dine-in, delivery, or carry-out in Kenton, Russell's Point, or Urbana. Jack and Doe's, the tradition lives on.
At Easton Water, we're fully committed to fulfilling our promises to our customers. As a locally owned, staffed, and operated company, our reputation is critical, and we mean what we say. We want to be your trusted source for everything water. If recent changes in the market have left you high and dry when it comes to drinking water, water softeners, salt, or anything else to do with the water in your home or business, We're here for you and would love to be your trusted water partner. Visit eastonwater.com or give us a call and we'll get you added to our route.
Hi, it's Warren Rupp. To see what a roof by Warren might look like on your home, please visit our website, roofsbywarren.com. And remember, we have over 30 years' experience in dealing with insurance.
When the time has come and your roof needs done, the name you can call is Warren. When it finally stops pouring, it's time to call Warren. Roofsbywarren.com.
Roofs by Warren. See us at roofsbywarren.com.
Here's an important reminder from Jacobs Auto Repair. While school's out for the holidays and the kids are home from college, it's a great time to make sure their cars are ready for the upcoming winter weather. Simple things like having the battery and tires checked, making sure the heater is warming, and the defroster is working properly. A good checkup for their cars can save the kids and you stress. The last thing you want is to have your child stranded in bad weather. Give Jacobs Auto Repair a call today and get on the schedule. 592-2233.
Chieftains defeat the Granville Blue Aces 29-21 to advance to the Region 11 championship game. Tavian St. Clair tonight had a terrific night passing for the Chiefs as he was, he was 13 of 22 for 223 yards and two touchdowns, including two bombs over the top to his buddy Riley Neer. Riley Neer caught the touchdown on the game's opening drive. He also caught the Chiefs' touchdown on the last score late in the third quarter. Riley Neer tonight, Brandon, I've got him down for 11 catches, 202 yards, and those two scores. Amazing game from Riley Neer.
Oh, he's electric when he touches the football. And that's why you seen earlier in the game when he had that 56-yard return. You really didn't see Granville kick it off to him. They were when they scored the next time, they had the onside kick that perfectly called, right. But just a one, you know, guy was offsides by a step, and then you know they started to squib kick it. But you know, I think when you look at Riley, I think teams need to. How are you not double teaming?
Yeah.
How are you not having a safety over the top? You know what's coming, and you still can't stop it. So,
They couldn't stop Chris Fogan either.
No, yeah. So
31 rushes.
It's like pick your poison when the Bellefontaine offense is clicking like they were tonight. So, like I said, you know, a gritty win tonight for Bellefontaine as you know they overcome some turnovers late in the fourth quarter, the fumble going into the end zone, and they held Granville out of the end zone on that fourth down, and you know Granville forced them in some turnovers. So. I think going forward, I think you're going to see, you know, there's no bad teams left in this thing.
Oh, no.
Now you beat the 3 seed or you beat the 2 seed.
Who was undefeated.
Who was undefeated. You beat Granville, who was undefeated.
Yes.
Now you have a familiar foe, back in the day foe, and Bishop Watterson coming in one loss. Got to see them a little bit. They are a very physical football team. So.
Yeah, unlike Granville, they're going to want to pound it down.
Yeah, they're going to want to run the football right at you, and it's going to be interesting to see, you know, how Bellefontaine, you know, game plans and tries to stop that.
Well, we will find out on Sunday where that game will be, but wherever it is, we'll be there for you on 107.3 The Drive as the Chiefs will play for a regional championship and a chance to advance farther than any team in school history with a win next week. Tavian St. Clair, like we said, 223 yards passing. Riley Neer, 202 yards receiving. Chris Fogan, 201 yards rushing. The Chiefs piled up 465 yards of total offense tonight. They outgained Granville 465 to 430. Hats off to Beckett Long and the Granville Blue Aces. Long was 28 of 45 passing for 323. Three TDs in those two interceptions. And, again, a lot of big plays throughout the ball game tonight, and the Chiefs get the victory by the count of 29-21. So, for Evan Cook back at our studios, for Lou Vito and for Gary Kauffman, we're going to sign off here tonight with a reminder that you can watch this game in its entirety and for free on PeakofOhioTV.com, or just go to PeakofOhio.com. You'll see it there, the link for it, in the morning. So, for Lou, Gary, Evan, and Brandon, I'm Dave Bezusko. Chiefs win it tonight, 29-21, and on to the regional finals. Thanks for listening to Bellefontaine Football on 107.3 The Drive.